14. Next up, we'll see if Northern Illinois can pull off a shock against Florida State. Our friend Mr. Corso seems to think so. You don't agree.
I don't agree with Coach Corso. I think Florida State has the better team. I think they're going to be motivated. I think they're going to win this game.
So hugs all around for many generations of the Shaw family as Stanford survives a rugged one, 20-14. The football feast continues now in South Florida. Champions of the ACC in the MAC, the Seminoles and the Huskies, the Joe Tessitore and Matt Miller.
Thank you, Chris, as we welcome everybody to the 2013 Discover Orange Bowl. A pair of conference champions ready to meet up, including one team out to prove to everyone that they belong. Here's Ayla Brown to honor our country.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ayla Brown.
Ayla Brown, former Boston College basketball player and current recording artist, to get our night started here at Sun Life Stadium. Northern Illinois and Florida State. So many have labeled Northern Illinois as the ultimate Cinderella, saying this is a David versus Goliath matchup. They have traveled far to be here from the Midwest. In fact, they have 26 buses with 1,300 students traveling 24 and a half hours to meet the ACC champs here in Miami. An improbable matchup. A Mid-American Conference team taking to the big stage of the BCS. For so many of you, probably the first time you're getting familiar with the Northern Illinois Huskies. A team set to take the field that has won 12 straight games. From DeKalb, Illinois, just outside of Chicago. They draw upon that recruiting base there in Metro Chicago. Over 22,000, many feel the most famous alum. How about the voice of Homer Simpson? As we welcome the Northern Illinois Huskies. The first time a team from the Mid-American Conference has taken the field to play in a BCS Bowl. Took an overtime win in their conference title game and then an envelope please six-spot jump reveal in the standings to earn this trip to South Florida. With a record-setting quarterback, a confident bunch. They won't accept being dismissed as unworthy or overmatched. These Huskies are ready for primetime.
Once upon a time, a big-hearted team from a cold town up north found themselves 1,000 miles away, face to face with a mighty foe.
Come with me now.
I'll go take you down. From sometimes snowy, always warm DeKalb, Illinois, these are the Northern Illinois Huskies, MAC champions, right where they believe they belong. On a national stage, against a national power, the Florida State Seminoles, the ACC champion, boasting one of the best defenses in the country. Come with us now for the story of Cinderella, David and Goliath, Northern Illinois, and Florida State in the Discover Orange Bowl.
Folks, that they are just as hungry, just as excited for this Discover Orange Bowl. Chief Osceola has made the trip down here to Miami Gardens, a top Renegade, for one of those special moments, the pageantry and traditions that only college football can bring about. Of course, their foundation built on being a national power program, but yet it's been 7 years since Florida State has been in a BCS bowl themselves. Back here after that 06 Orange Bowl, back then a triple overtime loss to Penn State. Now they come here trying to reestablish themselves among the national elite. Jimbo Fisher, his third season. Such high expectations this year for the Noles. Said, I'm not disappointed in our season one bit. I'm also not satisfied. You have to learn how to be champions. And they hope to be champions of the Orange Bowl here tonight. Florida State Seminoles, with that mighty defense, they are ready to roar. From Sun Life Stadium in Miami Gardens, Florida, it's the 79th Discover Orange Bowl. The ACC champion, Florida State Seminoles, taking on the 12-1 Mid-American Conference champion, Northern Illinois Huskies. As we say, good evening, everybody. Glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore alongside Matt Millen. And Matt, we know there's folks out there wondering how Northern Illinois is even going to compete in this game. Then there are those that have seen Jordan Lynch, their quarterback, play out there. He's outstanding. He was top seven in the Heisman Trophy, led the nation in total yards.
Convincing, Joseph. He's convincing. And he's a guy who can do a lot of different things, least of which is throw the football. You ask him to throw it down the field, he's accurate. You ask him to run the football, he can do that. He can beat you with his feet. He can beat you with his arm. He's also a great leader. He epitomizes what this Northern Illinois Husky team is. They're tough. They're gritty. And Joe, they're ready to play this game here tonight.
No doubt about it. With Leach leading the way, they're not just happy to be here, folks. Motivation, confidence in abundance, as well as the thought of silencing the critics.
All we did was do our job and win. So there's always going to be people out there, you know, not wanting us in there.
We've all been told we're not good enough to play in other conferences. So we've already, that's how, like, we live life, basically. If you come to Northern Illinois, you've been told somewhere else that you're not good enough to play. So we hear that all the time.
Every time they go out there, they have something to prove. And it doesn't matter if it's in the Orange Bowl or against any one of our opponents we played this year. They have a chip on their shoulder. That's the way they play.
That Northern Illinois offense with Jordan Lynch, they are facing their toughest challenge yet. Florida State's defense, they're fast, they're athletic. They're number two in the country in defense.
And they're number two for a reason, because they're also relentless. And yes, they're disciplined. And how do you know that? You watch them. This team runs extremely well. You're gonna watch, they're gonna try to get to the outside. I want you to count the number of white jerseys you see around the football. Not one through five, but seven. They do a great job with the discipline of scheme. Everybody always getting to the ball. Their linebackers flow well. Their corners flow well. This is a good tackling team and a very talented defense. And if the Huskies are going to do anything tonight, they're going to handle that front, Tez.
It's the one BCS game that had everyone talking when the matchups were announced. Now we will see if the BCS Busters can prove they belong. Northern Illinois, Florida State, set to go. From the Discover Orange Bowl is coming up, but first a look inside Nissan's Heisman House.
I got this. Is it the yoga?
Edmunds.com says the all-new Nissan Altima is a better car than Camry. To argue would be rude. Nissan Altima, with moving object detection. Lease now, just $199 per month. Visit ChooseNissan.com. Road and Track called Sentra an economy car, minus the look and feel of an economy car. Wonder how Civic and Corolla look and feel about that. The all-new Nissan Sentra, with best-in-class MPG. Lease for $169 per month. Visit ChooseNissan.com.
Whether your team won or lost, come into Outback January 2nd and get a free Bloomin' Onion when you say Outback Bowl.
Playmaker Teddy Bridgewater and the Big East Champs take on one of the nation's best defenses and the Gators' relentless rushing attack. The All-State Sugar Bowl, Louisville, Florida. Coverage begins Wednesday at 8 on ESPN.
Big game coming up, huh?
Feels good to be undefeated.
That's right, it does.
You know this guy?
Tweet to win an appearance in next year's Nissan Heisman House.
Welcome to the Nissan Pregame Shift. Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy and the Bowl Championship Series.
Just 24 hours before Northern Illinois found out they made it to the Discover Orange Bowl, their head coach, Dave Doran, left the program, took the job at NC State. They promoted offensive coordinator Rod Carey. Maria Taylor is with the guy making his coaching debut on this big stage. Maria.
Coach, in 1998, Northern Illinois was making history for breaking a 23-game losing streak. Now you're here at the BCS Bowl game. What makes you believe that this team is ready to take on Florida State?
Because everything we've thrown at them all year, they've done. And they've come back from, and they've handled all the adversity. So I know we'll handle this.
And Florida's athleticism has allowed them to be second in the nation in total defense, but you have a dual-threat quarterback in Jordan Lynch that has already broken four NCAA records this season. What are you going to do schematically to put him in good situations to be successful?
Do what we do all the time. Try to get him in space. Let him make plays.
Thanks, Coach.
You bet.
Joe?
Thank you, Maria. Dave Doran has made the trip down here to see what his team can do here in the Orange Bowl. Came down to support them. Now the new head coach at NC State. Of course, Florida State, led by Jimbo Fisher, 3 years into bringing the Noles back to national prominence. This was a team many picked to win the national title this year. This has been the Nissan pregame shift. Florida State won the toss. They defer. Northern Illinois will receive. Tommy Lee Lewis, three kickoff touchdown returns in his career. That's a school record. Dustin Hopkins, who could make history himself tonight, will be kicking off. Underway in the Discover Orange Bowl. tripped up out at the 24-yard line by Ronald Darby.
Flag already.
Flag comes in at the end of that kickoff return.
One of the things, Des, that's going to happen when you have a major
after
underdog.
Dead ball, personal foul, number 9.
Carlos Williams, who plays special teams as well as their nickelback. Now you see him giving Santa Catarina a little shove.
Nicely done by Santa Catarina not to do anything, but when you're dealing with all this, sometimes you have a big chip on your shoulder. You really want to believe that you do belong here with the big boys, so things get a little chippy.
Jordan Lynch and that record-setting Huskies offense. Start the night at the 39-yard line. And you will see plenty of this. Lynch running the ball and diving straight ahead to the 44, a gain of 5, tackled by Tyler Hunter. Jordan Lynch named second team All-America by the AP. He finished the season with the same 258 points responsible for as the Heisman Trophy winner, Johnny Manziel. Tuck it, run it, and be wrapped up. It'll make for a third and a long 2. A look at Matt Millen's game plan. What do you got for us tonight, Matt?
Well, the first thing this group has to be able to do, they have to, A, believe they belong. It's all from the neck up with this group. And then they've got to get Jordan Lynch. You heard him talk with Rhea Taylor. They've got to get him in space. He's got to use his legs and his arm. And then defensively, this defensive line has some talent, and they've got to be able to win against a really talented offensive line.
32. Lynch sprints to the near side, and his first pass of the night is incomplete as he was looking for 5'7" Tommy Lee Lewis, well covered by first team ACC-er LaMarcus Joyner.
That was exactly where they wanted to be able to get this offense, test. They wanted to be getting third and short. If they could get to that, they thought that they felt that they could manage the third and short. They do not want to get in third and long situations.
So Ryan Neer comes on to punt as Kenny Shaw sets up shop back at the 12-yard line for Florida State. End over end, not much hang time, but fair catch out at the 17-yard line. E.J. Manuel, the senior quarterback for the Noles, attempting to make history, trying to become just the second quarterback to win 4 consecutive bowl games. West Virginia's Pat White, the only other one to ever do it. Devontae Freeman and the veteran, versatile Lonnie Pryor in the backfield for the Noles. And E.J. will open up through the air. And he's able to find Rashad Green. What a dangerous weapon Rashad Green is for Florida State.
Yeah, well, one of the things that Rashad Green is fast. And that's the one thing that you're going to see from this offense versus this defense. There is great speed on this Florida State offense, and they want to be able to get in space and use that speed.
Out of the gun on 2nd and 3. And he gets this complete for a first down out to Rodney Smith. 6'6", Rodney Smith. Millen's game plan for Florida State.
Well, it's pretty simple. When you're that good athletically, you want to establish your athletic dominance in this game. And then you can't beat yourself. You don't want to do penalties or turnovers and that kind of thing. And then defensively, they've got to punish Jordan Lynch. He is the main cog in that offense. And if you take him down, you slow him down, that bodes well for you.
A run option and keep it with Freeman, but not much there at all as he was met that time by Jamal Bass as well as Sean Progar. You like the front 7 of Northern Illinois. You watched a lot of film on them. Thumbs up.
Yeah, I like this group. I think they're gritty. I think they've got some toughness. They have good discipline. You saw it right there. on the outside with that Progar. That Progar, 95 and 90 on the other side. Baxter, you're going to like these kids. They got next level skills.
The offensive line for the Huskies, that concerns you. And we saw a three and out to start the game on that side against that talented Florida State defensive front. Second and 11 now. Manuel, a pump, only able to get back to the line of scrimmage as he slid down there.
It looks like their left guard got away with a little bit of a hold. But I got to tell you, what you're going to be impressed with, at least I was on tape, is this defensive line. And what they wanted to be able to do was get a rush with just four. Now, first series, things look, you know, that's fine. This is where they want to be. Third and long, and let these guys bring the rush. Watch 90 on the outside, Baxter, and 95 on the other, Bogart.
Some of the 1,300 students that made their way down here. Third and 11 as they try to rally support for their defense against the ACC champs. DJ Manuel, plenty of time, and that is caught. Looks to be just a bit short of the first down line. Nick O'Leary depend on the spot as he found his tight end over the middle, O'Leary. Jimmy Ward, safety, came up to make the tackle. First team all conference selection is Ward.
I want you to see this. You know, I have watched a lot of film this year on offensive lines, and I've got to tell you, Tess, this is the most athletic line I've seen in college football
now,
this
year. Wait a minute. We broadcast number one Alabama earlier this year when they were number one.
Right.
More athletic than Alabama's offensive
line.
They're
more athletic than Alabama. I don't think they're better than Alabama's offensive line. I think Alabama's a little more physical. But this group, up and down the line, can bend, they can redirect, they run extremely well, they are athletic, and they're also short.
They come up just a few links short of the line to make.
They also, in this game, they are going to go for it, but they enjoy a 55-pound per man average across the board advantage in their size as opposed to this defensive front.
Keep in mind, in these short yardage situations, E.J. Manuel, 6'5", 238. Florida State 1-for-4 on fourth downs this year. So fourth and inches on their opening drive of the Orange Bowl. Big James Wilder comes into the game with Lonnie Pryor. And Wilder gets the call, and he muscles his way ahead. It'll be a first down for Florida State.
One of the things you really wanted to see early, we talked about it. They needed to believe they belong. And I believe this Husky defense is the group that's going to push them over. You can't tell anybody on this front. There's 91 in there, Anthony Wells, Nayball Jefferson, 99. We talked about Progar, talked about Baxter. They play like they belong. They got themselves a little bit of a chip, and I like that.
Freeman the lone back here on first down as Manuel checks at the line. And they go with the pitch to Freeman. And Freeman scoots ahead. Just past the 45-yard line, tackled by big number 99, Nabal Jefferson, one of the 15 National Football Foundation Scholar Athlete Award winners. This guy is a great example of the good that college football can do in a young man's life.
They're being kind there at 6 foot, but I'll tell you one thing, he's got the heart of a lion in him.
Second and 7 for Manuel. He goes underneath that time as he's able to find Greg Dent. He'll make for a third and about 2. Sean Evans came over, made the tackle on Dent.
And you can see
their looks on.
They're going to have rotation through their defensive line. But what they haven't been able to do is get to the throw. And E.J. Manuel can sit in the pocket. Now, what he's going to have to do is he's going to have to be patient. And conversely, the secondary for Northern Illinois is also going to have to be patient. Because at one point, one of them is going to lose their patience and take the shot.
They're in a long one. Wilder comes back in, converted the fourth down moments ago. They go play action. What a nice fake by Manuel. And he's able to find O'Leary. And Green space ahead. He fumbles the ball. And Northern Illinois' Demetrius Stone comes up with it. A flag is down as Stone gets the fumble recovery.
We talked about the patience test. We talked about the patience. And the team who lost their patience first was Northern Illinois. And they got messed up in coverage, and they left O'Leary alone in the flat. They tried to cover down the field with two defenders. They felt the mistake, then came back, and they forced, of course, the turnover by Florida State on O'Leary.
See the effect that turnovers have had. Rashawn Melvin came up and put that helmet in there.
Before the fumble, blocking the back on the offense, that penalty is declined. First down.
Well, if you're an underdog, if you're a Cinderella, you're going to need the ball to bounce your way. Turnovers always key. Nick O'Leary coughed it up there. Northern Illinois ball when we return.
Discover card, how can I help you?
Oh, you're real?
You know I'm real. With our new card, we're always here to talk.
Well, that's good.
Because I don't have time for machines.
Some companies just don't appreciate the power of conversation.
Real people.
Mm-hmm.
It's like I'm calling the land of machines.
Now, with their robot voice.
Oh, I don't like those machines. Oh.
Now, how can I help you?
Oh. I don't even remember.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Talk to a real person. Get the new IT card at discover.com.
Sick of this thing popping up.
I know. Cable's more annoying than...
I shouldn't have to stop watching a show or cancel a recording.
Cable's worse than... Totally. You need to upgrade to DirecTV and get the new Genie. She lets you record 5 shows at once.
Wow. DirecTV is better than...
Record 5 shows at once with the new DirecTV Genie. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
I say the same thing twice. I'm awkward when I speak. Ain't got the perfect smile. Don't turn heads on my street. Trying to be a superstar like everybody else. But being myself is something I do well. Express yourself.
Across thousands of cities and millions of miles, T-Mobile's nationwide 4G network has the U.S. covered from coast to coast. Nationwide 4G coverage from T-Mobile, reaching over 220 million Americans. See for yourself at T-Mobile.com.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the WatchESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Beautiful night here in South Florida. Joe Tessitore, Matt Millen, Maria Taylor with you. The 79th Discover Orange Bowl. Nick O'Leary fumbled it away. Northern Illinois recovered, and now Lynch and company back to business. His first completion of the night. It goes to Perez Ashford.
I'm going to go back and watch Rashawn Melvin and what he does. This is his coverage right here. Okay, so he sees the delay. He's going to go down, and he gets caught in between because he also feels the delay coming back. You see how he turned? You know, he does a nice job of coming back and getting that head right on the ball. And that's a big turnover.
Tommy Lee Lewis on the end around, and Lewis is taken down right at the 40-yard line. It was a good play by Nick Moody. See the Northern Illinois defense. Rashawn Melvin came up from that corner position, forced the fumble. Demetrius Stone, who went to high school locally at Miami American, back home coming up with a recovery.
That's to see how they're doing this right now. They're trying to spread the defense to try to get as few numbers in the box as possible, and then they're allowing him to be able to see the numbers and work inside. So they're waiting for them to declare coverage, and then he's working numbers.
3rd and 4, Lynch. Going to try to get there on his own. Can he beat the man to the edge? Oh, what a hit that time by Telvin Smith.
Remember, we talked about the great team speed at the start of the game, and we showed you how they get lots of people to the ball. This is a great example of it. Telvin Smith just runs inside out along with Christian Jones. Christian Jones, number 7, takes a great angle. He gets there first, and Smith finishes it off. That's just great team speed.
And they are going for it on 4th and 1 from their own 44. Roll the dice. He's going to pooch punt it. Just a quick punt here, and it takes a great Northern Illinois bounce inside the 10 all the way down to the 5-yard line. So he can do it all. Jordan Lynch, a 52-yard punt. He needed just a little speed to the edge, and he took a big shot from Smith on that third down.
Hello! Hello!
Let me see.
Are you kidding me?
Oh! Oh! Oh!
That's it.
No.
Mr. Woodson?
Oh, hello!
Hello!
Hello.
Caleb, I got someone I want you to meet.
Hello. AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network, covering 3,000 more 4G cities and towns than Verizon. Rethink possible.
Don't just reject convention. Drown it out. Introducing the all-new 2013 Lexus LS F-Sport. An entirely new pursuit.
At Farmers, we make you smarter about insurance. Because what you don't know can hurt you. What if you didn't know that boxes by the curb make you a target for thieves? Or that dog bites account for a third of all home liability claims? What if you didn't know that 1 in 7 drivers is uninsured? And the grease fires have to be smothered. The more you know, the better you can plan for what's ahead. Get smarter about your insurance.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Nobody tells stories about that punt on 4th and 1. Nobody relives that miraculous fair catch or taking a knee. And nobody remembers the guy who brought cheese and crackers.
Late night whipping it, we're magnificent. Yeah, I go hard in the fourth quarter.
6 crunchy tacos and 6 Doritos Locos tacos. Taco Bell's Variety Taco 12 Pack. A game day tradition since right now.
The Discover Orange Bowl is brought to you by the new Discover It Card. Finally, a credit card that's changing the game. The 2013 Lexus LS and all-new LSF Sport, an entirely new pursuit. And DirecTV, if you call yourself a sports fan, you gotta get DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
You'll be seeing beautiful shots of Sun Life Stadium courtesy of the DirecTV Ultimate Picture Cam tonight. Florida State, nation's longest active bowl streak, 31 consecutive bowl appearances. 9th time they're in the Discover Orange Bowl. In deep here after that 52-yard punt by Jordan Lynch. E.J. Manuel had his incomplete off the hands of big Kelvin Benjamin. First Florida State. They were thought of as a national title pick by so many coming into the year. They started 5-0. They had that disappointment when they were number 3 in the country at NC State, losing 17-16, and then would go on from there through the ACC, capture the ACC championship. First time in 7 years they've done that with the win over Georgia Tech. Jimbo Fisher. James Wilder Jr. breaking free for a first down out to the 20.
This is what they should be doing, just getting after this defensive front. Just, this is a big, athletic, physical group. And they're young, Tess. This is a really young offensive line. They should have the entire offensive line back next year.
And Fisher's a recruiting guru, putting together another stellar class. Play action now. Manuel with time downfield finds Greg Dent. And he is pushed out at about the 39-yard line by Sean Evans.
Sean Evans is giving a lot of space on the outside. And they respect the speed of Florida State. And this is what I was talking about. Now, he's got to get out of that. See, as soon as he opens those hips, Dent has him beat. He just turns that thing to the outside. You judge. You judge width, you judge depth, and you judge hips as a receiver. He saw that as soon as those hips were flipped.
Dent had a superb bowl game practices. All the coaches told us this was the guy that had a great December and is ready to peak here. Lonnie Pryor now, and Pryor running hard, and here goes Lonnie Pryor. Touchdown, Noles.
This is just a nice job on that left side of just being physical and getting in good position. They're going to take, watch, they're going to get right here on the nose and then inside out. He needed to come down tight, and he did not do that, and the backer can't get over, and then Pryor just uses his speed and outruns everybody. Tyrone Clark, that backer, if you skate just a little bit, Tess, you don't come downhill and force that thing, you gain an extra gap in its history.
Lonnie Pryor jumped into Jimbo Fisher's media session the other day and asked like he was a reporter and said, hey, how can you get the fullback more involved? That's a good way. 60-yard touchdown run by the senior.
Don't just reject convention. Drown it out. Introducing the all-new 2013 Lexus LS F-Sport. An entirely new pursuit.
Greatness is not given. Greatness is taken. When the weak and the distracted are resting on their reputations.
Over 40 years of hydration science in every bottle, so you can take what's yours.
This is the world of today's PC. A dark age where imagination has been banished and shapeless, gray designs have remained unchanged for decades. But now, we have the freedom to choose a different kind of personal computer. One with breakthrough touchscreen technology, sleek all-in-one design, and brilliant HD picture. The PC reimagined by Vizio.
This week at Office Max, everything you can fit in this bag is 20% off. Saving 20% on everything your company needs? It's a big deal. Check your December 30th Sunday paper or print the coupon at officemax.com.
Who is that?
Andy Lang.
Texas Chainsaw. Rated R. Starts Friday.
Aerial coverage is provided by Goodyear. 7-0 Florida State. Tires that go the distance make Goodyear a fan favorite. Goodyear more driven. And that touchdown lead for the Noles thanks to a career-long run by Lonnie Pryor. He went 60 yards, Matt.
Let me show you anatomy of a touchdown, Joe. It's really a beautiful thing. These two have this one and this one. He's outside. He is eyeballing this backer. He's got to come down. You'll get outside. The safety will be the free hitter from the middle of the field. You're going to see him. He's got to take a good angle down inside. And this is where speed comes in. Lonnie Pryor, who's really not known for speed, although he can run, he outran the angle. Poor angle by Stone, the safety, and it's six quick.
Takes a knee. Let's check in with John Saunders. John?
Joe, Matt, thanks. Slot Sports Center right now brought to you by Discover Card, taking you to the Rose Bowl, presented by Vizio. Kelsey Young takes this touchdown run and a 7-0 lead for Stanford. This one was a tight game and late. Uswa Omanum, defensive player of the game, with the interception to seal their first victory in the Rose Bowl since 72.
What a year for Stanford. And the big one against Oregon, and now they cap it with a Rose Bowl victory this afternoon. Northern Illinois offense, 2 3-and-outs. They need to get something going. Oh, and he missed a wide open Martell Moore.
And that test you cannot miss. In a game like this, you've got to have some big plays. You know, traditionally, and this through this year, Northern Illinois has not started fast. They've kind of stumbled in their starts. This is an opportunity on the double move that Moore runs perfectly, and Lynch has to be able to hit that throw.
Lynch here looking for some running room, and Lynch is able to get it out to the 30-yard line, a gain of 5. Wednesday night on ESPN, it's the All-State Sugar Bowl. Number 21 Louisville against number 3 Florida. Will Muschamp's Gators and that great defense against the Big East champs. Coverage begins Wednesday night at 8 o'clock on ESPN.
Bridgewater should be completely healthy for that one, Tessa. That will help a lot for that offense for Louisville.
Teddy Bridgewater, the quarterback for Louisville. Heroic performance he had to close out the season, dealing with injuries to earn that spot. Jordan Lynch facing a 3rd and 4 here. Design quarterback run, and he will be 3 yards short. Matt, there is just no room against the middle of that Florida State defense. Well, Jordan Warner with the tackle that time.
Yeah, there's some good, and there's good reason. They're going with that young offensive line against that defensive front. And I want you to watch on the inside. They don't get any movement whatsoever. In fact, they're just getting mauled in here. That's just getting overpowered.
3 straight 3-and-outs now. That defense that we talked so much about before kick, showing up exactly the way we thought they would. This is a fake here. They are going with a fake punt, and pulling it off is Desroy Maxwell. How about that? From their own 32 into Florida State territory.
That's a great call by Rod Carey. Rod Carey's, he knows he can't fall behind in this one. And he had that thing. Desroy Maxwell ran it perfect. They had it set up. This is all about numbers on the punt team. If you get him, you take him. And he was. Desroy got to the edge. Not the fastest guy, but he got walked down. But a big first down and their first one of the night.
They needed something. Carey wasn't going to let the game just linger. First head coaching gig. And he goes with that in the Orange Bowl. And now Lynch met at the line of scrimmage again. This time it was Mario Edwards Jr., the freshman defensive end.
Yeah, they wanted to be physical. Remember, Jordan Lynch had something to say this week. Watch the end of this thing. That's Bjorn Warner. That's on the 3rd down. He's letting them know that he's there. That's Bjorn Warner on Jordan Lynch. And like we said, Tess, Jordan Lynch, he is this offense.
The pass now on 2nd down. Swings it out of the backfield. Tommy Lee Lewis. Oh, a little half step in midair there as Lewis turns on the speed. And it is 1st and goal, Northern Illinois, as their former coach looks on.
Dorner's going to love it. Now, he got it. Tommy Lee Lewis right down here in South Florida. Tommy Lewis is about a buck 50 soaking wet with a rock in his hand, but he can flat out fly. Watch his little Dion move in the middle. He gave that little kick step. That's to let everybody know he's got it. That kid can go.
First and goal. Lynch. There's just nothing there. Lynch keeps testing it. And he keeps finding Garnett and Gold right in his face. That was Nick Moody coming up to make the tackle.
Yeah, and we said that this Florida State team had to establish the presence, the physical dominance, and their athletic superiority. And where you really see it is up front. Now, the Northern Illinois coaches knew this could be a problem with their young offensive line.
Second goal, Lynch with time, throws it short and underneath and incomplete. He was looking for Maxwell, who had the fake punt go for a 35-yard run, but it'll be third and goal for Northern Illinois.
Rod Carey's calling the plays down to the sideline, and then up in the booth, his quarterback coach, Bob Cole, they're in constant communication. And they know, and they're reading things. Carey said, look, if I don't get a good feel for it, I'm just gonna kick it back upstairs. But he's going to try everything on the front end with formations, which is what he's doing right now.
Receivers stacked to the near side. They go to the far side, and it's incomplete. He was looking for Martell Moore, who was being ridden by Xavier Rhodes.
Now, here's the difference, okay? Xavier Rhodes, that looks close, but he starts the bump right from the start. Watch, gets his hands on him, continues with it the whole time. Now, he's got to pull off that eventually. They may have gotten away with one right there, but Rhodes is a big physical corner.
So out comes Matthew Sims, the junior from Hannibal, Missouri, who's been good on the short range stuff this year. This attempt will be coming from 25 yards. And the Huskies are on the board. That Florida State defense, they put up the wall once they got inside the 10. Florida State's only allowed 3 first quarter touchdowns on the year. 7-3 game here in the Discover Orange Bowl early, and that makes for a happy Rod Carey getting on that board.
I'm having a contraction! I'm having a contraction! We're in labor. The book says you should stay calm. But this is our first kid, and we've chosen to panic. Gun it! For the baby. Here it comes! Out of mommy's way! So get an Allstate agent and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Mayhem is everywhere. So get an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
What's better, bigger or smaller?
Bigger!
So which would you rather have, a big treehouse or a small treehouse?
If it's big enough, you can have a disco.
Oh, yeah.
Why do you not want a smaller treehouse?
Because it wouldn't be able to fit a flat-screen TV, and then the TV would be about this big, and you would have to hold the wire. In the position you would hold the wire, you wouldn't be able to see the TV.
That's a pain in the buns.
Yep.
It's not complicated. Bigger is better. And AT&T has the nation's largest 4G network.
All right, now that you're part of Junior Motorsports, let's see what you can do. You know, on second thought, I know something you might be perfect at.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
File your federal return for only $9.95 with TaxSlayer.com.
No success is overnight. It's about working hard. And smart. It's the culmination of decisions. It's where you see yourself going and choose to get there. In the 2013 GS, our boldest response ever, there's no going back.
The utterly shocking sensation of being on a business trip where everything goes right, backed by a 100% satisfaction guarantee. Feel the advantage. Feel the Hamptonality.
Glad you're with us for the 2013 Discover Orange Bowl. The DirecTV mobile studio on its road to the Discover BCS National Championship. It has arrived here at Miami Gardens. Over 63,000 miles, countless stops. And now it'll camp out here as we will get set for the big one next week. Number one Notre Dame, number two Alabama. South Florida, the center of college football here this week through next. 7-3 Florida State as Northern Illinois able to get the Matthew Sims field goal thanks to the efforts of that guy, Desroy Maxwell, who had the 35-yard run on the fake punt. Keep the drive alive.
Maxwell completed a gutsy decision by Rod Carey to take that thing. He took the chance and Maxwell carried it out.
Ivor Riedel to kick away. Here's Carlos Williams who will just take a knee. Thursday night on ESPN, it'll be the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. Number four, Oregon. Number five, K-State. This is going to be a good one. You got Marcus Mariota on one side. You got Colin Klein, the Heisman Trophy finalist, on the other. Coverage going to begin Thursday night at 8 o'clock on ESPN. K-State going to be able to handle that Ducks offense, Matt?
No, I don't think so. I think they're going to struggle with it. But conversely, I also think that the Ducks are going to struggle with Calvin Klein and that option. Colin Klein, I should say.
Little touch pass ahead here to Rashad Green. Green cuts back against the grain there and then is tackled by Jimmy Ward.
That's a nice job by Ward to stay behind, because that Husky defense, they've headed that whole thing off and he had to cut it back, and Ward does a nice job of just staying behind and then making the play, because this thing could have been out the gate.
A year ago was Tavon Austin in this game, time and time again, getting big chunks of yardage off that little tap pass forward. Second and four, bad snap. E.J. Manuel at 6'5", able to go up and get it and make the most of it as he gets back to the line of scrimmage.
And that was just the athleticism of Manuel, just to get up that high, first of all, and then be able to, he picked up maybe a half a yard or so. Watch this, it's up high. And he just goes and gets it. You see Baxter did a nice job. He had the edge that time. Sets up. Here's a third and about five. This is a big deal right here for this Husky defense.
35, Brian Stork starting center, and he has most playing experience among that young offensive line. That high snap moments ago. Second team all conference is Stork. And a timeout called by Florida State.
Timeout.
C.J. Manuel will come over and talk things over with Jimbo Fisher.
Second. Timeout.
E.J. Manuel, a young man who's had a tremendous career, but it was revealed recently that some of the pressures that he's been dealing with this season, far beyond the pressures of trying to lead a team to a national championship. His mother, Jackie, yesterday just had her eighth and final chemo treatment, and she's battling cancer. We wish her the best, but obviously a lot for a young man to have to deal with.
And to deal with it, his parents have been with him the whole time. He's one of those guys who's really tight with his parents, and this weighed heavily on him. And I know, having gone through that chemotherapy with my own mom, it stays with you all the time. And to go through this whole season and manage it, that's a credit to him.
Jackie, unable to be here tonight in Miami. He was diagnosed with breast cancer before the season started, and E.J. was quietly dealing with it. It weighed so heavily on him. Third down and five. That was deflected at the line of scrimmage that time by Ken Bishop.
Bishop, nice rush. Felt that he was going to throw it back underneath. They went man-to-man coverage on the outside, but Bishop was able to get his hands up and knock that thing down. That's a big play for this Husky defense.
Bishop is a Florida native.
He had Rashad Green in the middle of the field. Green gets a half a step on your test. That could be ugly.
They came after the punt of Kaysen Beatty. It's a short punt. And it bounces at about the 37-yard line. So Northern Illinois gets a stop there against that Florida State offense. What a ride it was to arrive here at this point for the Huskies. They had that MAC championship game in double overtime. And then they needed some help. UCLA, they needed to get up to the top 16. Their head coach the next day took off for NC State. Texas lost that Saturday night. Then come that Sunday, Rod Carey was named the head coach, and they would find out that they earned an invitation into a BCS Bowl as they were able to get all the way up to number 15 in the BCS standings. And the fact that another AQ conference, automatic qualifying conference champion, was below that mark, Northern Illinois, becoming the first Mid-American conference team to make it this far. Dave Doran looking on here. He's now the head coach at NC State. As we come to the end of the first quarter, we saw the speed of the Noles, that 60-yard touchdown run by Lonnie Pryor, and then the guts of Northern Illinois on the fake punt. 7-3 game here at Sun Life Stadium.
Ladies, why is your man watching this snoozer of a game? Because I'm on his fantasy football team. So he gets for 10 points if we win or not. Boom. It's a guy thing. Like Dr. Pepper 10. With all 23 flavors of Dr. Pepper and just 10 manly calories, it's like a fantasy soda, but you can drink it.
Get in there, hot dog!
It's what guys want. Like scoring touchdowns with players that fake coaching. Woo! So close. So keep the reality TV and lady drinks. We're good.
Dr. Pepper 10, it's not for women.
Discover card.
I asked my husband to pay our bill, and he forgot.
Yeah, I've got one like that too,
but you have the new IT card, and it's your first time making a payment, so there's no late fee. Really?
Yep. You don't even have to ask.
And we'll never raise your APR for paying late either.
Oh, that's great. So,
is your husband off the hook?
No.
He went out for milk last week and came back with a puppy.
Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it.
Well, forgiveness is a wonderful thing. Yeah.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Late payment forgiveness. Get the new IT card at discover.com.
Turn 1, Daytona. Riverside exit, I-95. Variante Ascari, Monza. Mile 7, Highway 1. Air Siphon, Nürburgring. The Horseshoe, Twin Peaks Boulevard. Every famous curve has an equally thrilling, lesser-known counterpart. Conquer them with the Lexus IS Performance Line. Featuring the IS 250. Real performance demands real precision. This is the pursuit of perfection.
You know, I look at her and I just want to give her everything.
Yeah, you know, everything can cost upwards of...
I did not want to think about that.
Relax, relax, relax. Look at me. Look at me. Three words, Dad. E-Trade Financial Consultants.
So I can just go talk to them?
Just walk right in and talk to them. Dude, those guys are pros. They'll hook you up with a solid plan. Wait a minute. Bobby? Bobby, what are you doing, man?
I'm speed dating.
Get investing advice for your family at E-Trade.
2012. It's almost over, so why not make an end-of-year resolution with Kia's holiday sales event? J.D. Power & Associates ranked the Soul highest in its class in initial quality, and the Optima, most appealing midsize car. Add in the Sorento, and Kia has some of the highest safety-rated vehicles on the road. 2012 may be coming to an end, but the best time to buy a Kia is right now. Get 0% APR plus $1,000 bonus cash on the Sorento.
Has been stellar as expected as we start the second quarter here, Matt.
Yeah, we talked about their great team speed, and it showed up a bunch in this first quarter. Now, Jordan Lynch, he runs pretty well, and he's about a 4-5 guy, but I want you to watch Christian Jones, 6'4", 240 pounds, get help from Smith over the top. Because they're able to handle their offensive line with their down four, these linebackers have been able to roam free. You see Williams coming back inside, Christian Jones again. They're able to use their great speed, and they've basically been untouched.
Lynch, 8 carries for only 20 yards, 2nd and 8. And that was far beyond Martell Moore. He was covered by Xavier Rhodes.
At one point, Jordan Lynch, he's got to do something with his arm. They're not going to win the fight inside in the run game. His offensive line is going to get dominated by this defensive front. Jordan Lynch is going to have to use this arm. They're going to have to dial up some throws. So on the outside, what Florida State's doing right now is they're locking them up man-to-man. And they're saying, we like our guys better than your guys. We think we win this matchup.
Athlete for athlete, they have. Third and eight. And that's off the hands of Moore as he tried to time that route. Lynch.
It's a little high.
Struggling a bit here, passing the ball. Just 2 for 8 to start the night as he will go over and have a chat with Rod Carey. New head coach, was the offensive coordinator.
Well, this is Martell Moore. Now, this ball is on him quick. You got to make this catch. I mean, it should have been put on him. It should have been down a little lower. But when you have the opportunity in this game, those are missed opportunities.
And Kenny Shaw secures it just beyond the 20. Knowles offense and E.J. Manuel back out there, not far away from that great scene in South Beach when we come back.
Regular appetizers, you'd be sharing them by now. Taco Bell's new Loaded Grillers. Appetizer taste of spicy wings, tasty skins, and beefy nachos. Each just 99 cents and wrapped up just for you.
At Cheez-It, we expect a lot from our cheese.
Surprise!
Did you plan all this?
Pretty mature, huh?
Wow, that is really mature.
Go ahead and blow out the candle.
Oh.
I am so good at this.
We take the time for our cheese to mature before we bake it into every delicious cracker. Because at Cheez-It, real cheese matters.
We've been taking the Cadillac ATS all over the world and testing in different environments. Have you seen this road we're going down? Yes. It's like Armageddon outside. This is an adventurer's dream, a driver's dream.
For a limited time, lease this all-new ATS for around $299 per month. Season's best from Cadillac.
What's better, faster or slower?
Faster!
Yeah, what's fast?
My mom's car and a cheetah.
Okay.
A spaceship.
Spaceship. And what's slow?
My grandma's slow.
Would you like her better if she was fast?
I bet she would like it if she was fast.
Maybe give her some turbo boosters.
Tape a cheetah to her back?
Tape a cheetah to her back. Okay. Seems like you've thought about this before.
It's not complicated. Faster is better. And iPhone 5 downloads fastest on AT&T 4G.
We welcome you back to the 2013 Discover Orange Bowl. Glad you're with us, Joe Tessitore, alongside Matt Millen. And reporting from the field tonight, Maria Taylor. Beautiful scene. Over downtown Miami. We're here at Sun Life Stadium. Jordan Lynch trying to get some advice as to how to solve that Florida State defense. 3-3 and outs. The only one that wasn't so far tonight for Lynch was the fake punt possession. And now quickly, Kelvin Benjamin able to get 13 yards there. He goes 6'5", 242 as a receiver. You talk about a matchup problem for the Huskies.
Well, plus he can run. And so they're going to give him on the outside. Melvin gave him a lot of room, and they're just taking advantage of it. And because E.J. Manuel is not getting any pressure, and that's a cause for concern for this Husky defense. However, it's great for Manuel, man. He's throwing great.
And coming around here is Greg Dent. And look at how quickly Dent gets himself out near midfield.
They take anything. They're going to give this space, then Florida State's going to take it. Like we talked about the speed, and it's certainly an advantage for Florida State. But at one point, if you're a Husky defender, you're going to have to be patient. And as the field shortens, that's when you can defend a little bit better.
They bring some pressure. It's picked up, but Manuel throws it to the outside of Benjamin.
Benjamin.
Manuel, who waited his turn behind future NFLer Christian Ponder. Well experienced in the postseason. Remember, Ponder had injuries a couple years ago, Chick-fil-A. So Manuel trying to become just the second quarterback to win four consecutive bowl games in college football history. Play action. And here's Pryor again. Lonnie Pryor with a spin move and a first down for Florida State.
So they give you speed and then they also give you misdirection. So they start you running one way and they bring him out the backside, and Pryor gets in the flat quick. Just dump it off underneath and let him run.
Remember, he had that 60-yard touchdown run earlier, showing that burst once he hit the sideline and straight ahead speed. Florida State, 9.6 yards per play. Play action now. Manuel. Kenny Shaw is tackled right away that time by Sean Evans.
Tess, one of the reasons why they're enjoying great protection is Manlik Watson, number 71, right here. He's the right tackle. Now, this is 100% man. This is an outstanding athlete, but he's a big man, 320 pounds, great movement, bends well. He's just raw. He's only played 16 games in his entire football career.
One of the most outrageous backstories you'll ever hear to becoming a starting linebacker in the Discover Orange Bowl. Starting lineman, excuse me, as Pryor comes up short. Manlik Watson, 6'6", 320. Originally from Great Britain. Was a JUCO transfer, but he came to the U.S. by way of playing college basketball at Marist in upstate New York. Gave up hoops, tried heavyweight boxing for a moment. Florida State spotted him playing junior college football, brought him in. He's their starting right tackle. And to a man, almost every coach will tell you, maybe the best athlete on the team. And he's just learning football.
He's just getting it. I mean, this guy has made huge strides in the last year, and he's a legit player.
Third and two. DJ Manuel on third and two. He was pressured, was hit as he threw, and is that a completion? No. Kenny Shaw made a great play on it to try to get his hands underneath. The pressure came from Jimmy Ward, and Manuel couldn't get much on it.
And so they roll the dice. Jay Neiman, the defensive coordinator, he brings Ward to safety. They're bringing him off the edge, and he comes clean right in the back. Hits him down low, which is nice and safe, but he forced that bad throw, and that will force this 50-yard field goal. And that's a good call by the official, who was right there. Side judge saw it perfectly, made the right call.
And Dustin Hopkins with a chance to make history. This a 50-yard attempt. And can you believe that? Hopkins, who's been so good from 50 plus, a ridiculous 5 for 5 this year, misses that. If he had hit it, he would have the most field goals in NCAA FBS career, more than anybody before. But you gotta get it inside that post, not on it.
This year, share everything. Share brotherly love. Share one-ups.
Mom?
The Share Everything plan lets your family share a pool of data across 10 devices with unlimited talk and text.
Now get a Lucid by LG free.
A European-inspired suspension, but it's not from Germany. A powerful, fuel-efficient engine, but it's not from Japan. It's a car like no other, from a place like no other. Introducing the all-new 2013 Chevrolet Malibu, our greatest Malibu ever.
Discover card.
I want to ask you a couple of questions.
I've got nothing to hide.
My bill is due today, and I haven't paid yet.
Is that a confession?
Have I committed a crime?
Nope. Actually, with our new card, you can pay up till midnight online or by phone the day it's due.
Sounds convenient. How do I know you're telling the truth?
Because I work for Discover Card.
Got a witness to verify that?
Just you. You called me.
Okay, that checks out.
You recording this?
Yes, I am.
Good, so am I.
I would like a copy.
Copy that.
Copy that.
Copy that.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Payment flexibility. Get the new IT card at discover.com.
Dustin Hopkins had made 10 straight field goals coming into this Discover Orange Bowl. 50-yard miss moments ago, 7-3 Knowles. Let's check in with Maria Taylor. Maria?
Here with Coach Dave Doran, and you're sitting here in the stands. How difficult is it to not be in the sidelines with your team right now?
It's definitely different, I'll tell you that. It's a lot of fun to cheer these guys on, though, but I haven't been in the stands in 17 years.
Well, how often have you been able to talk to them during this week, and what's been your message?
I've talked to them. I said, go out there and play your hearts out. You know, everything they've done has got them to this point. Just be themselves, not flinch, and play together.
Jordan Lynch, that's incomplete. Unable to connect with Daniels. Maria?
Coach, you said that this team has a lot of character. They worked their way here. What do you believe is it going to take to get this offense back going so they can get ahead against Florida State?
They just got to be patient and continue to run the ball. They got to get a few passes going to loosen up Florida State's defense, but they will. Jordan will get it going.
What did you think about Coach Carey faking the punt on fourth down?
I loved it. I thought it was beautiful.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Maria, as Lynch has missed his last six pass attempts. Dave Doran set for that North Carolina State job back on December 1st, less than 24 hours after winning the MAC title game. And then a day later, Northern Illinois would get their invite to the BCS, and Rod Carey would be promoted from offensive coordinator to head coach. You see the struggles on third down tonight, third and 10 here.
Yeah, if they don't slow down this pass rush, Bjorn Warner has been bringing major heat, and they've been able to just rush four and get pressure. Mario Edwards, the freshman on the other side, doing the same thing. They're dominating this line of scrimmage, and that's the difference.
Blake is running down, and that ball is incomplete as Jerron Brown was the intended target, but well covered by Ronald Darby, who many believe could be the next great one in the long history of Florida State defensive backs.
And so, Tess, even when you don't get pressure, and Lynch had time there, you have to be perfect because they're locking these receivers down. And every guy is walked up in man coverage, and they're tight. They're tight across the board.
Fourth time of three and out for Northern Illinois. Offense doesn't look quite the same as it did in MAC play. Ryan Neer on to punt again. Kenny Shaw back deep for the Knowles. And it takes a Northern Illinois bounce. Check in with John Saunders in the studio. John?
Well, it's time for the AT&T All-America Player of the Year update. And how about Manti Te'o of Notre Dame? Definitely a nominee for the All-America Player of the Year. Finished number two in the Heisman Trophy voting, the highest ever for a player exclusively playing defense. If you'd like to vote, text the word vote to 34763 from your mobile phone. Winner will be announced in Discover BCS National Championship. Back to Joe, Matt, Maria.
Thank you, John. Manti Te'o and the Irish going to be coming here to South Florida tomorrow. With all the coverage leading up to that Discover BCS National Championship game. Play action. E.J. Manuel going downfield and getting it complete to Rodney Smith. And Smith out past the 40-yard line.
They're trying to do, and they've got, again, no rush whatsoever on the inside. Good protection for Manuel. He's able to scan the field, and the ball's where it has to be. Now, they're giving them a lot of room on the outside, and they're taking advantage of it, Tess.
And that look courtesy of the DirecTV Ultimate Picture Cam. Keep it on the ground here. And Devontae Freeman, a gain of six there. And you bring up Manti Te'o. Last time Notre Dame lost a game, it was to that man in the Noles Champs Bowl a year ago. Beat him 18-14.
And this is a better team now than they were a year ago. And the reason they're better is this young offensive line. And I mentioned young, all can return. I don't know if they all will, but all are capable. They should all come back. They need the experience, and they will be a dominant force next year.
Second and four. Another first down as he's able to get it to Rashad Green. Green was the star, had his breakout performance in that victory over Notre Dame a year ago in their bowl win. Just a sophomore, led the team in catches this year for Jimbo Fisher's offense.
That's fine on the outside, but none of that happens without what's going on the inside, Tess. This offensive line right now is taking the game over. They're opening holes in the inside. They're protecting. He's not getting touched. Manuel should have a field day.
Manuel. He throws it there to the 30-yard line where it is incomplete. That was low intended for Greg Dent.
And the linesman had another good look at it. Came from underneath and he saw the ball all the way through. He gets his fingers underneath it. But see right there, it came through. That's a good job by the linesman. Very, very good job. Now the linesman is the guy who's at the line of scrimmage and his eyes go down. That's his secondary read. You see how it hit in there, and then he tried to cradle it back. But he saw it the whole way. I think that's a good call by the official.
The previous play was ruled an incompletion. It will be under review.
So they'll take a look. And we'll take a break. 7-3 Florida State. Jimbo Fisher looking on as moments ago Matt Moore and the SEC crew we have here confirmed an incomplete pass.
This is a good job by the line judge Mike Shirey, and he sees it completely right there. The ball, he had his hands under it, but it got into his elbows, Tess, and then you can see this is another good shot of it. It hits the ground. Nope, that's from the side, not as good. But we had another shot where you could see it clearly, and a good call by the official.
Matt, Florida State, 240 total yards to Northern Illinois' 86. He had a 7-3 game.
Yeah, one play away from going the other way.
Devontae Freeman on second and 10, and he is taken down in the backfield by Anthony Wells.
Quick move on the inside by Wells. Able to get into that backfield, sets up this third down, third and long. Watch Wells. He just slips it right there. Really well done.
Florida State yet to convert on a third down tonight. 0 for 4. Neither team has. Northern Illinois 0 for 6. This is a third and 11. Can the defense come up with a stop again? And they do. As Kenny Shaw was the intended target that time. Pressure came against Manuel by Sean Progar.
Yeah, Progar came off that left side. That's a nice rush. And that's what they need more of. And Progar, number 95, and I said he's got, you can see him up top here, he's got some next level skills. He's not afraid to rush. He's getting the back on him, and he just powered him.
Vocal leader of that defense. Jason Beatty on a punt away. Angelo Sebastiano, return man, called for the fair catch here. He does so inside the 10 at about the 7.5-yard line.
Yeah.
That's one of the things that we've watched here tonight is this Northern Illinois offensive line really not getting any push in the run game. The line of scrimmage does not move at all. And when that happens, I don't care who's running the football, whether it's Jordan Lynch or Adrian Peterson, you're not going to get any movement. You get no movement, you get no rush.
They had to replace five starters on the offensive line heading into the fall. Then they lost one of their best to injury. Rod Carey was the offensive line coach when the season started. Now the head coach. Here's Lynch now. Sprints to the near side, being chased down. Boy, was that dangerous. As Nick Moody had a play on the ball that time, but it falls harmlessly incomplete.
Telvin Smith made the play. And then Moody almost had the pick. Watch Smith just come from the inside out with that great speed. He tried to throw it away, but Moody almost had himself a pick.
Jordan Lynch has missed his last eight pass attempts. And make it nine as he was looking for Jason Scheffler, the senior tight end. And now a third and 10 and pin deep here.
You know, he's put a lot of mustard on his throws, too, Tess. I mean, Jordan Lynch looks like he's letting all that energy out all at once, because his balls, every one of them, they've had a couple drops, but, man, he's had thrown with much touch here tonight.
Yet to convert a third down. And Lynch, good athletic effort to Martell Moore. It'll depend on the spot.
Thank you, short test.
And it looks like they're going to mark him short, yes. But a tremendous effort by Moore just to get that foot down.
Nice job of coming back on the defender. Had great awareness also. Ooh, I don't know. That foot looked like it may have been.
Watch the ball, though. But that foot, you're right, Matt.
Yeah, you can see.
If you look
right
at that foot that he planted, it looked like it was right on the line. Instead, the ball was marked short of that 18-yard line.
What we really have to see is where the ball is when he went out of bounds, because that's how they're going to mark it. They're going to mark where the ball is.
The officials talking things over.
They're going to look at the position of the ball when he goes out of bounds.
The ruling on the field was a completion out of bounds. We will review the spot of that foul, of that out of bounds.
That's hard to see if he moved that ball forward. Here's another shot of it. Foot is down. It's to his left side. That's close there, Tess.
It's a very good point by you, Matt, because his body is straight vertical. We know that the left foot is at the line to make. He brings the ball to his left hip, which is aligned with that left foot right there. Let's bring in Steve Shaw, who's the SEC's coordinator of officials, our rules expert. Steve, what are they looking at here?
So what the replay official is looking at right now, it's not where his feet are, it's where that ball goes out across the boundary. And he's got to have indisputable evidence that it is short of the line to gain, or that he would make the line to gain to overturn this call. So what we see right here, that ball, you know, you were talking about which hip it's on. It looks like it's behind where his foot is, but it's so very, very tight. Let's look at this one here. So where that ball is, I'm not sure that there's absolute indisputable evidence.
There's the toe print.
And the toe print's nice.
But it's where the ball is.
Looks nice, doesn't it?
So the only way is if you can say where it aligns with that toe print, you got to look at the ball, and that's where you need the indisputable video evidence to prove it true. Thank you, Steve.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Northern Illinois is not charged with a timeout, as this was a booth-initiated review. Fourth down.
Now, the play stands. That's different than the play being confirmed. The play standing means there was not indisputable video evidence to reverse the call. Basically, can't confirm the call correct, can't prove the call is wrong, so the play on the field stands, that mark stands, and thus Ryan Neer is on to punt away to Kenny Shaw. Gasol comes up to make that at the 48. Now there is a flag down back at the 12-yard line where you saw Florida State rushmen coming after near there. You know, new rule college football. Defenders can no longer try to jump over a punt shield blockers or they'll be flagged for a personal foul. Let's see if that's what they came up with here. That's a new rule in college football this year.
You could go straight up, but you can't try to leap over them.
And that shield that's in front of near, that's what they're concerned with player safety. They do not want to see players trying to jump over the punt shield blockers, and that's when they will flag it.
There was no foul on the play.
That's a good not call.
So they looked it over, and they say they're going to let that go.
Good not call. This is a good officiating crew. They've been on this game all night. Now you're going to watch him. Now, if he can go up, he can't launch himself over the top where he would be flipped. That was the danger. They're putting themselves in bad position. So that, I think that's a good non-call.
So obviously, great field position for Florida State as it was the fifth three and out.
And good
they
field position
upon Northern Illinois, and then the punt barely getting past midfield. And Manuel, play action, plenty of time. And out of the backfield, Lonnie Pryor, who is able to spin past midfield to the 47-yard line, tackled by Melvin.
And so Jay Neiman, the defensive coordinator for this Northern Illinois defense, is not changing. He's letting his guy, he's going to give him some room, and he's just being patient. And like you said, Tess, the Seminole team, they have dominated in terms of numbers, but they're just one play away from this thing being a different game.
Second and five. James Wilder Jr. And it'll be third and about 2.5 here. And that's what Jay Neiman, the defensive coordinator, really wanted. He said, listen, we need to be decent enough on first and second down to make sure that it doesn't end up being a long night for us. They need them in third downs. But, you know, that offensive line of Florida State, such a big edge against for Northern Illinois. Look at the size advantage, man.
Yeah, almost 50 pounds a guy, 55 pounds across the front. This is just a big physical group, and they've moved the line of scrimmage. So to counter that, Northern Illinois has gone to some movement, and when that happens, sometimes it's feast or famine. Sometimes you get them, sometimes they get you.
Third and three, and he's passing, and it's incomplete. So getting them to that third down spot.
I'll tell you what's been a nice little matchup on the outside. It's Sean Progar against Menelik Watson on the outside. Progar working against Watson. Look at right here. Watson's going to get his hands up in his face and takes that helmet right off. Now, by rule, Progar has to stop right there. The helmet comes off. He's got to be able to stop. Now, this ball comes out. It's incomplete. Sets up a fourth down. But that's a nice little battle going on over there.
0 for 6 now is Florida State on third downs. Jason Beatty back out there. Sebastiano with his heels on the 10-yard line. And gets the fair catch at the 12. Just a 7-3 lead. E.J. Manuel and the Noles frustrated after that last third down.
You build a reputation by not breaking down. Consider the Silverado 1500, still the most dependable, longest-lasting full-size pickups on the road. And now we've also been recognized for lowest total cost of ownership based on important things like depreciation, fuel, and maintenance costs.
Get 0% APR financing for 60 months plus $1,000 bonus cash, plus trade up for an additional $1,000.
From outstanding value to standing the test of time, Chevy runs deep.
I paint people from my life, mostly. My ex-girlfriend, seventh grade math teacher.
Who is this?
That's Pete, my
Allstate agent.
The starving artist has an Allstate agent?
He got me
the Allstate Value Plan. It's their most affordable car insurance, and you still get an agent.
I call it
the Protector.
Is that what you call it?
The Protector.
Okay.
The Allstate Value Plan. Are you in good hands?
sick of this thing popping up.
I know. Cable's more annoying than...
I shouldn't have to stop watching a show or cancel a recording.
Cable's worse than... Totally. You need to upgrade to DirecTV and get the new Genie. Just you record 5 shows at once.
Wow. DirecTV is better than...
Record 5 shows at once with the new DirecTV Genie. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
This is the best party ever.
That is an understatement.
I'm so glad we finally got in.
This place is banging. Hope it's cool we sit at the bar. The other tables look taken.
I'm sorry, do we know you?
These are the best in town.
The ambiance is strange, but the food is incredible.
This is our apartment.
Our apartment.
Oh.
Weird name.
Real restaurant taste, wherever your party's at. Introducing new Tostitos Cantina chips and salsa.
More chips, please, waiter.
And dos cervezas. Gracias.
Arriba, arriba.
The Discover Orange Bowl is brought to you by Taco Bell. Sometimes you gotta live más. Cadillac, the standard of the world. Coca-Cola Zero, real Coke taste and zero calories. And Verizon, share the holidays with the Share Everything plan.
Northern Illinois enjoying the jet skiing just off of South Beach. Not that guy, though. Not Jordan Lynch. What did it mean to us? He wasn't allowed. No jet skiing for the star quarterback. They didn't want to see anything happen to him.
Smart move by the Huskies.
Visions of him in an inflatable yellow tube with a rubber ducky, keeping him safe. That's not a safe place to be. All night long, it has been the Florida State front shutting him down. Vince Williams, Timmy Jernigan getting after him.
Yeah, and Williams ends up making the tackle, but the guy who made the play up there is up on the outside just playing extremely well. He's been playing all night like this, is Bjorn Warner. If Warner missed it, Williams is right there to take advantage of it.
That was overthrown once again, looking for Martell, but it's going to get the flag drawn here as Xavier Rhodes had coverage on Martell Moore.
Martell is the one guy who has the kind of speed that they think can win, but Xavier Rhodes has just blanketed him all night long. He has not gotten away from him at all.
Rod Carey said that Moore is the one guy that pro scouts will look at the most.
Pass interference. Defense number 27. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Northern Illinois will take anything they can get against this defense.
Tess, I'm a little surprised with all this tight man coverage that we're not seeing rubs or picks. We're just getting man-to-man stuff on the outside and letting him go. And at one point, you're going to have to scheme a little bit more. When you don't have the raw talent, you've got to start scheming things.
And what did Carey tell us the other day? He said, we have every pick play known to man in our offensive game plan against Florida State. Here they go with the screen. Akeem Daniels, and Daniels has first down yardage out to the 40-yard line.
Yes, you want to know something? This is kind of weird. I'm not going to go with hurry up. But I think they've taken the worst of it. I think you're starting to see a little bit of confidence breeding here in this Husky offense.
They go with the bunch formation to the near side, give one look to the screen, and then Lynch takes it. They've been bunching up those receivers in the empty sets.
When you do bunch, when you stack guys, you do motion and get guys behind, all you're trying to do is look for rubs and picks and bump off defenders underneath. Now they're spreading it out for Lynch to see the whole field, and then that will define who can come. The good news is for Florida State is they've been able to rush with just four.
And Lynch thrown down immediately by Timmy Jernigan and Vince Williams again. Look at Jernigan. I mean, this kid's going to be something special down the road.
Yeah, they know that they're dominant right now. Jernigan on the inside is just throwing people around. You're going to watch him just come off the ball. They're just toying with people. That line of scrimmage is not moving, and the defensive line is dominating that front.
Need to get to midfield. Third and eight. Lynch met again and just thrown back by Christian Jones, Vince Williams, and Tyler Hunter.
These linebackers are enjoying an outstanding day here tonight. The reason, again, we go back to the defensive line. They have kept them completely clean. And now he looks down the field. There's nowhere to throw the ball. They've locked them down man-to-man. And then here come the backers. There's Williams, and then inside out, Christian Jones.
Take a look on the outside. They're just taking coverage away. All man-to-man, safety over the top to help. No place to throw the football, and the backers clean them up.
Ryan Neer kicking away again, and Shaw calls for the fair catch. Aerial coverage is provided by Goodyear. Tires that go the distance make Goodyear a fan favorite. Goodyear, more driven. Discover BCS National Championship. The Irish, the Tide. Notre Dame looking for their first national title since 88. And Alabama on track for its third title in 4 years. Coverage starts next Monday, 8 o'clock. On ESPN. Devontae Freeman tackled in the backfield close to the 15-yard line by Jamal Bass. So number one versus number two right here on this field. All the history. Right? You just say Notre Dame and Alabama, and Matt, we've been here the past few days. You can feel it bubbling up in South Florida.
Yeah, the thing that I'm looking forward to, Tess, and Manti Te'o's a heck of a player, but the guys playing in front of him, that defensive line against the offensive line of Alabama, that's going to be one heck of a matchup. That big old Nix, that's a man.
Lewis Nix.
You better show up to block him.
Lines up the middle for the Irish. Here's Devontae Freeman in space, and Freeman lowers the shoulder out past the 40-yard line.
Looks like they may have had man coverage, and he got picked on the inside. Wasn't able to get there. You know, watch him right here. That's the guy who has a cover. See, he loses him, runs back underneath, and once that happens, it's over. You have to jump your coverage right away. Jamal Bass wasn't able to. He had to run underneath the block, and that got him beat.
And now Manuel's going to pull it from Freeman's gut, and he gets to the 49-yard line. Coach's trophy presented by Dr. Pepper. Of course, it'll be awarded next Monday night. Discover BCS National Championship game, 8 o'clock on ESPN, right here at Sun Life Stadium. Going to be the 27th year the trophy will be presented to the national champion. Rutgers place primed and ready. Field is like a putting green down there. Second and five, and that is complete to Rodney Smith. Smith from right here in Miami. 39 straight games with a catch now for Rodney Smith.
They're just being patient again. They're betting on the offense making a mistake. That's what this Northern Illinois defense is doing, because they are being extremely patient in their coverage. They're giving up the underneath. They're going to make the tackle. And as that shield field shrinks, those throwing lanes become tougher and tougher in windows to throw into.
Manuel with time, and he's got Kenny Shaw. And here come the Noles.
Here comes that offensive line protection. Nice job of protecting him. And because he has that time, he can let that thing develop to the middle of the field. They find that hole in the zone, but there's nobody around him to throw. Look at that thing. Good protection, O-line.
Over 300 yards of total offense now, and yet just a 4-point lead as they look to add to their cushion. Manuel, look at the time he has. Finally a bit of pressure. And he's able to get it to Shaw, who planted those feet on the far sideline at about the 19-yard line.
Okay, so Tess, this is what I was talking about. All of a sudden, you're on the 25-yard line. That field shrinks. And so there's no threat of anything going deep. And so the windows and angles for throws, they change. The windows get smaller, the angles get tougher to throw, and Manuel has a tougher time finding. Because he can root move and run, he buys time and finds a receiver. Great shot, a nice struck field right there.
Second and four, swings it to Kenny Shaw. Shaw makes one cut, but just wrapped up at the 6-yard line by Jimmy Ward. It'll be first and goal, Noles.
Yeah, see what they did there. They ran the corner off, Ward can't lose the edge. He's got to defend it outside in. And he gets there eventually, but not before they pick up this first and goal.
Here's Shaw again. And he stumbles his way inside the five as he was trying to extend himself. So, second and goal.
Ward got tackled by, I think, the 5 or 6 yard line. Reached up and grabbed them. That's been the best defense in that outside stuff. They don't have the speed to be able to get inside out. And so they're just taking that inside and dumping it on the outside. And they're forcing them to have to run to him. Rhymes couldn't get there.
Devontae Freeman. And tackled for a loss that time by Rashawn Melvin.
That's a good read by Melvin. He's out there on the corner, and as soon as he goes back inside, only 15 seconds left, they're going to take a timeout. As soon as he gets down inside, he reads it quickly, test. Big tackle in the backfield.
Timeout. Check in with John Saunders, Florida State timeout.
Guys, coming up on the Buick Halftime Report, I'll be joined by Mark May and Lou Holtz as we will take a look back at the Outback, which went down to the wire. A tremendous battle in the Rose Bowl. A classic matchup between Pac-10 and Big Ten, and Georgia with a big win in a slugfest against Nebraska. Coming up on the Buick Halftime Report.
Look forward to it, John. 17 seconds they put on the clock here before the half, and we will visit with John Liu and Mark May. 7-3 in a game that Florida State has dominated with the exception of some key third downs. And Northern Illinois rolling the dice and coming up on a fake punt, setting them up for a field goal. But both lines for Florida State have had their way, and yet just a 4-point margin as they look to add to it here. It'll be third and goal.
And they have not been good on third down. Third down in this first half has bit them in the rear end.
0-for-6. We haven't had a third down conversion in this game yet.
They're spreading them out.
Percentage, 70%. Here's your third and goal.
Watch a quarterback draw. Nope. Could be a quarterback draw. The numbers are right for the inside. Now they have a back in there, so the numbers change.
Manual to pass. To the end zone. Did he get it? Yes, they say Rashad Greene somehow got it in. Went up in the air and brought it down for the score.
Looks like he got his left foot in and his right foot was out. In, out. Good call by the official. Right on top of it again. Great job officiating.
Stabbing that left leg was Rashad Greene. Look at this.
Nice control. Has the ball all the way through. That's well done.
And finally, the payoff for the Noles offense. Hopkins makes it 14-3. Discover Orange Bowl. Glad you're with us, Joe Tessitore. Matt Millen, Florida State line play has been far superior. You told me all week long that was the big concern. It's only 14-3. Northern Illinois comes second half. What has to happen to deal with that, though?
Well, I think a couple things. I think the first thing is when we talked to him this week, you heard Rod Carey talking about we're going to save something for the second half. And I wouldn't be surprised in the second half if you don't see more picks, some rubs, trying to get some inside guys open. They have not had any open receivers in the first half. They have locked them down man-to-man. I think that's the first thing. And then I think the second thing, you might see a little bit more aggressive calls in the blitz game for Northern Illinois. They'll use the field to their advantage. If it shrinks the field, you might see a little bit more pressure. But their patience, although they're 3-1 in yardage test, they're only down, you know, they're down here 11 points, so two scores.
E.J. Manuel at what he's already done tonight. 28 attempts in the first half, 242 yards, and moments ago that 6-yard touchdown toss to Rashad Greene. Jordan Lynch, not what he's used to. Been dominating opposing defenses as the leading rusher in the country among quarterbacks. And they're just going to squib it here, and enough man will take it and get it just beyond the 35-yard line. That was Boomer Mays. Florida State got things going with Lonnie Pryor as he showed off that speed, and then NIU, they didn't want the game getting away from them. They rolled the dice, converted with a 35-yard fake punt that set up the field goal. Dustin Hopkins' 50-yard attempt was off the post. He was trying to make history with the most field goals in FBS history, and then moments ago, Green going up and bringing it down. And Northern Illinois takes a knee. 14-3 at the half. Florida State, the ACC champs. For those who thought they weren't hungry for this one, trust us, they are. Here's Maria.
Coach, 328 yards of total offense, but just 2 scores. How do you improve execution in the second half?
Just finish in the red zone down there. We had a couple plays we could have made, we didn't make. We're moving the ball, we're doing what we want to do. We just got to be a little more consistent on offense, get a couple things on special teams. They did a nice job with the fake, and we had a penalty there, get cleaned up. Defense is doing a very nice job.
Yeah, defensively, you hold it to only 111 yards. What's been working really for the defense?
I think we're keeping great leverage on the ball. We're not letting them out numbers in the box. We're beating our defensive line's beating blocks up front, allowing us to cover down the field.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Thanks, Maria. His defense is doing a job on Jordan Lynch. Just 12 carries for 24 yards for Jordan Lynch. 14-3, Noles on top. Now let's join John Saunders, Lou Holtz, and Mark May back in the studio for the Buick Halftime Report. Gentlemen.
Joe, thanks a lot. This is indeed the Buick Halftime Report, and with Mark May and Lou Holtz, it's been a great day of college football. You don't expect blowouts when you come down to bowl time, and we did not get that today, especially if you started by watching things in the Rose Bowl presented by Vizio. Dave Shaw and Stanford taking on Wisconsin. And Stanford on a 16. Kelsey Young, a little end around here, and takes off for a touchdown.
Look at the big guard get out in front and shield the block in there into the end zone. Terrific job of execution by the offense.
24 seconds to go in the first half. Wisconsin's down 17-7. Kurt Phillips rolls left and finds Jordan Frederick. 4-yard touchdown, first career touchdown reception. It's a 17-14 game. Under 3 to go. Wisconsin down 20-14. Phillips throws the pick to Amonin. Stanford goes on to win it 20-14, much to the surprise of Lou Holtz. We're expecting Wisconsin to win. We'll have more when we come back. Jadeveon Clowney with a big hit against Michigan.
This halftime report is presented by the new Buick Enclave. It's smart, made beautiful.
Shoot, I missed a payment.
Discover card.
I missed a payment.
Oh, shoot.
Shoot, this is bad, isn't it?
Oh, no, we're good.
This is your first time missing a payment.
And you've got our new card, so we don't
charge you a late fee for that.
Plus, we won't hike up your APR for paying late either.
Man, that's great.
It is great, man.
Thank you.
Well, thanks for your help.
Yeah, no problem. Call back anytime.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Late payment forgiveness. Get the new IT card at discover.com.
These new phones they got us are great.
Yeah, it's the Galaxy Note 2.
You can do two things at the same time. You can watch videos and text.
Or you could watch the earnings report and take notes, like we're supposed to.
So, can I get it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Either of you put together the earnings reports?
Yes, me, totally.
Why don't you tackle the next quarter while we go to lunch? Poopa bladder?
Yep. Keep up the good work.
We'll keep up the good work.
Do more with the new Samsung Galaxy Note 2. For a limited time, get 2 flip covers for the price of 1, exclusively at Verizon.
So, as you can see, GEICO's customer satisfaction is at 97%. Mmm, tasty.
And cut! Very good.
People are always asking me how we make these GEICO adverts, so we're taking you behind the scenes. This coffee cup, for example, is computer animated. It's not real. GEICO's customer satisfaction's quite real, though. Ah, oh, this computer-animated coffee tastes dreadful.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Someone get me a latte, will you? Please.
For more than 60 years, Wrangler has been making jeans more comfortable. Fine by me.
Wrangler jeans give you comfort where you want it. They don't cut and bind like most jeans.
Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans are made with a U-shaped construction. They don't cut into you like jeans with a V pattern.
Room where you need it, comfort where it counts.
The most comfortable jeans you'll ever wear.
There's nothing like Wrangler comfort.
Wrangler.
Real comfortable jeans.
Not bad, dude.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
New Year's clutter is no match for someone with big ideas. With a new project in mind, some how-to knowledge to give us an edge, and more savings down every aisle. It only takes a few twists and turns for those bright ideas to make the new year even brighter. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Start fresh and save with HDX 20-gallon totes, a special buy. It's just $5.88 a piece.
It's almost over, so why not make an end-of-year resolution with Kia's holiday sales event? J.D. Power & Associates ranked the Soul highest in its class in initial quality, and the Optima, most appealing midsize car. Add in the Sorento, and Kia has some of the highest safety-rated vehicles on the road. 2012 may be coming to an end, but the best time to buy a Kia is right now. Get 0% APR plus $1,000 bonus cash on the Sorento.
At GoDaddy, we love to help small businesses.
And one of the best ways to grow your business is with GoDaddy's website builder.
You can build a custom website in minutes.
Now that's fast.
By the end of this game, you or your company can have its own website.
Cool.
Cool.
GoDaddy website builder.
Get online,
build a great website, and never miss a customer.
Get your domain name and website
at GoDaddy.com.
Start the new year with a new domain, just $9.99, now at GoDaddy.com.
Welcome back to the Buick Halftime Report.
Alongside of Mark May and Lou Holtz, I'm John Saunders. And Vincent Smith, welcome to Jadeveon Clowney. Guys, how'd you like to be Smith here?
Oh, my goodness gracious. He is the best defensive player I have seen in college football. 6'7", just so physical, Mark.
I wonder if he still has all his fillings intact.
If they are, they're rolling around the field right now. Jadeveon Clowney with a little salute, too. Connor Shaw to Ace Sanders in the back of the end zone, 31 yards. Two-point conversion was no good, 27-22. Michigan went ahead, but then Shaw finds Ace Sanders, but it was going between the two quarterbacks that worked for Steve Spurrier, Dylan Thompson to Bruce Ellington.
How do you let a guy get that wide open with 16 seconds to go?
I don't know. You're a coach. Tell us. Let us know how it happened.
That's why I'm here now.
33-28 is the score there. Lonnie Pryor takes off 60 yards, part of Florida State's 14-3 lead.
Driving would be so much easier if trouble would just tell you it was there. But it doesn't. So we put advanced safety features like a rear view camera with available rear cross traffic alert and side blind zone alert into the new Buick Enclave. Just one more way, the new Enclave is smart, made beautiful.
What'd you get?
Lewis is saving a few bucks.
Same here. Wendy's.
800-210-7057.
Wednesday night, Louisville and Florida will march into the Mercedes-Benz Superdome for the 79th edition of the All-State Sugar Bowl. The Cardinals, led by quarterback Teddy Bridgewater, the Big East Offensive Player of the Year. Florida safety Matt Elam says Bridgewater is the best quarterback the Gators will face this season. Florida is one of the best defensive teams in the country. The Gators give up less than 13 points per game. We expect mayhem when Louisville and Florida collide. The All-State Sugar Bowl, Wednesday at 8 on ESPN.
Tomorrow night, can't wait to watch Georgia and Nebraska, Capital One today. Aaron Murray, guys, had a tremendous game. Slant here to Chris Conley.
One of his five touchdown passes on the day, Coach.
Well, he just had a tremendous day. But like anything else, when you give up a lot of passing yards, it's because they ran after they catch.
45-31 as Georgia wins the slugfest. EJ Manuel to Rashad Green, who does a tremendous job to get that 1 foot down for the touchdown, their first third down conversion in the game. Florida State up 14-3.
Wife on ChristianMingle.com.
Joining is easy and free. Join ChristianMingle.com today.
This halftime report is presented by the new Buick Enclave. It's smart, made beautiful.
Time now for the Buick second half look ahead. Northern Illinois going 3 and out 5 times in the first half. The longest rush allowed this year entering tonight was 28 yards, and they allowed that 60-yard touchdown run to Lonnie Pryor. So, guys, as we look ahead to the second half, if you're Northern Illinois, you're in the game, but you've clearly been out-muscled.
What have you got to lose right now? Empty out the toolbox. Let Jordan Lynch, let him throw the ball each and every down. It doesn't matter at this point. You're down by 11. You've got nothing to lose. You're on a national primetime stage. Go ahead and just throw everything out the window. I pick every reverse I've got, reverse passes. Why not? Take a chance.
I'll tell you, as a football coach, I don't know what you say to him. There's nothing you can build on. You gave up 324 yards. The only thing you say, thank God we aren't down by 25. Let's go play.
I was going to say, when you look at the scoreboard, that's the thing that's most important if you're in the locker room right now, I would assume. So, the second half's still to come, but right now there's still plenty more to see down there in Miami, Florida. So let's go to country music star Jake Owen as he performs in the Discover Orange Bowl halftime show.
Shining bright, edge of the water, we were feeling all right. Back down a country road, the Florida girls are hot and the beer is ice cold. The Cadillac horns on the hood, my buddy Frankie had his daddy hook us up good. Girls smile when we roll by, they hop in the back and we cruise to the riverside. Whoa. Sweet tea, shot me a little like a shooting star. So I grabbed a beer and my old guitar. Then we sat around to the break of dawn, howling and singing our favorite song. Whoa, never gonna grow up, never gonna slow down. Yeah, we were shining like lighters in the dark in the middle of a rock show. In the dark, in the middle of a rock show. We'll be right back.
Congratulations. Thank you so much, Orange Bowl Committee.
Weather conditions.
It's easy, it's affordable, and it's just awesome.
Vistaprint.com/TV.
Discover Orange Bowl. Florida State 14-3 on top of the ultimate Cinderella. Northern Illinois, the first MAC team to ever make a BCS Bowl. Good Hands plays brought to you by Allstate. How about the good hands and a good foot to get it in by Rashad Green before the half, Matt?
Yeah, just an outstanding job of buying time. And Rashad Green, kinesthetic sense, Joe, body part awareness. Knew where that foot was, knew where the out-of-bounds mark was, and doesn't get much better now.
328 yards of total offense, but still it was just a 7-3 game until that moment, 11 seconds before the half. You take away the fake punt by Northern Illinois, and the Florida State defense is holding them to just 2 yards per rush. That Northern Illinois rush attack had been so potent all year long.
Well, one of the things we talked about all week long was they had to establish their athletic and physical dominance, and that clearly happened in the first half, and really shows up. Look at total yards, 3-1. And turnovers, they lost that, but the biggest thing is they were able to throw at will, and they actually, they ran when they wanted to, but the passing game was the bigger piece. And right at the end of the half test, at the end of the second quarter, E.J. Manuel had lots of time and then was able to buy some time with his feet to make that big throw for the score.
E.J. Manuel outdueling that guy, Jordan Lynch. Lynch just 52 yards passing, but more importantly, you know what he's been able to do on the ground this year. Was the leading quarterback in terms of rushing yards this year in college football, and he is being held to 24 yards on 12 carries.
Ordinarily, you would say, what adjustments can you make? But Joe, when you're physically being dominated, there are not a lot of adjustments you can make. Only thing you can do is get back to fundamentals, come off the ball nice and low and tough, and that's about it. One time you're gonna have to muscle up and man up and move them.
Florida State set to receive here. And a touchback that time, but Williams thought about it. Maria
Yeah, guys, I talked to Coach Rod Carey coming out for the half, and he basically said that his team is getting beat up front on the offensive line, so they want to throw the ball more. I asked how they could do a better job blocking. He said they need to get their pads lower. He also told his squad that whether they're up 11 or down 11, that they've been here before, they know how to respond. They just have to stick to their fundamentals, like you said, Matt.
That's excellent, Maria, because that's all you really can do, and he knows it. As an offensive line coach, you know in all of this, you can look at all the numbers, it all comes down to the same thing. Stance, come off low, pad level wins. That's what they're going to have to do.
A team that averages over 40 points a game being held to three here. And now this Florida State offense, will they get back to business? They were so effective just before halftime. Lonnie Pryor, who had that 60-yard touchdown run in the first half, finding success on the far sideline again, finally taken down by Jimmy Ward.
And a nice block on the outside by James Wilder, his running back, may be able to get to the outside. They, once they can get to the edge, this team, they can all run. Nicely done by Menelik Watson to be able to let him get to that edge. And then Wilder with the block, and he picks up the first.
Never had a long run past 49 coming into tonight. Goes for 31 there, had a 60-yarder earlier. James Wilder Jr. at that time near the 40-yard line.
James Wilder Jr. is just, he's really starting to come into his own. His dad was a heck of a player.
Tampa Bay Bucks.
Yeah, big physical runner, could do a lot of things, and this kid's in the same mold.
James Wilder, of course, long NFL career, played his college ball at Mizzou back in the early 80s. Junior goes 6'2", 226.
Yeah, he's
pounding back.
He's just a pup, Joe. He's, his best days all coming forward.
Play action now, and here's Pryor out of the backfield, stumbling down at about the 38-yard line. That was Tyrone Clark on the coverage.
That was the key. You see, he was on it right away. He was able to make a play. It sets up this third down. And this is a down that they have not been good at all night long. Their last third down, they had the score. They've completed, they've been able to convert one third down all night long. Let's see what they can continue.
It's 1 of 7.
Tight coverage on the top. Look up here, nice and tight. Haven't seen that all night.
And Manuel finds Green, and Green breaks free to the 20-yard line. So a first down for Florida State.
Sean Evans had the man-to-man coverage on Rashawn Green, who's just having a big night here tonight. Watch him back under. See how they stack him like that? That forces you as a defender to have to back off. That's good football, nice adjustment on the outside. So you take his speed, and because you make him back off, he can run away from his coverage.
Yards for Green there. First down just beyond the 20. James Wilder Jr. dragging NIU defenders with him to the 5-yard line. How's that for power?
That looked just like his dad. That was James Wilder. He was a big, powerful man, had the same high knee lift as Junior does. Watch him lower his pads and finish this thing. Right here. Now he's just going to pull his way through this. I tell you, that looks just like his pop.
By the way, he's bigger than George Rainey, the defensive end who was trying to tackle him. This time he's met, and it was Rainey on the tackle. Rainey's 222. Wilder, the running back, is 226.
Rainey, number 46. He's got himself a good motor. He has good movement. He plays a little bit too high sometimes. And Joe, you mentioned it. There's just not enough of him sometimes in that defensive front. But when he can move and use his movement, that's when he's most effective.
Second and goal, Florida State. Right on the edge of 400 total yards. Just a couple minutes into this second half. Offensive line has had their way all night long. Manuel to the end zone, and that was beyond Green, and a flag is down at the 5-yard line on the near side.
Down the bottom of your screen. Might be maybe lined up in the neutral zone.
Offside. Defense.
One-year-old Rod Carey, his first game as a head coach, and it comes in the Discover Orange Bowl. And he's hoping that his team doesn't get into too big of a hole here. Second and goal. First penalty against Northern Illinois tonight.
And this is like power on power, Joe. Let's see who wins it. That's going to be on the offense. Looks like the tight end jumped right there.
Cameron Irving, the left tackle there. Second team all-conference. His first year on offense was a defensive lineman before. Switched over to left tackle. Not an easy transition to make.
And Joe, that guy is just as athletic as Watson on the other side. That kid is a young one, and he's a talented, talented guy.
Ball now. Manuel to the end zone, but it was low and to the outside of Nick O'Leary. And he was covered by Demetrius Stone, who we told you has come back home here to Miami. Finished off that MAC championship game with an interception in the end zone in double overtime.
Yeah, and it's just he has coverage on a man-to-man on the outside. He held outside leverage, and they stayed true to the route, and Stone, by position, took the route away.
That ended a streak of 9 straight completions for E.J. Manuel. Now a third and goal.
If he doesn't buy time with his feet.
He scored on third and goal just before halftime. He looked Green's way. And he looked back to him, but this time incomplete. So that'll give the opportunity to Dustin Hopkins, the senior place kicker from Houston, Texas, to make history. Most field goals made in a career. Right now he's tied with Georgia's Billy Bennett at 87. Going to have the national record, FBS, for most field goals made in a career. Where he missed from 50, hit the post from 50, this from 25. Hopkins owns the mark with those golden shoes that he spray paints himself the day before each game.
He should spray paint his leg because that's a golden leg.
Sure is. Hopkins tops them all. Most field goals in a career in FBS. Dustin Hopkins, 17-3 game.
The more you prove, the more you have to prove.
The Cleveland Browns select Trayvon Richardson.
There's no way I'm going to lay down for anybody.
And everybody doubting me, saying I'm too small.
It's because you make it to the NFL doesn't mean you've made it in the NFL.
11 NFL rookies in the series you don't want to miss. Follow the Everything to Prove journey on Gatorade's Facebook page.
Nobody tells stories about that punt on fourth and one. Nobody relives that miraculous fair catch or taking a knee. And nobody remembers the guy who brought cheese and crackers.
Late night flipping it, we're magnificent. Yeah, I go hard in the fourth quarter.
6 crunchy tacos and 6 Doritos Locos tacos. Taco Bell's Variety Taco 12-pack. A game day tradition since right now.
Discover Card, how can I help you?
Oh. You're real?
You know I'm real. With our new card, we're always here to talk.
Well, that's good.
Because I don't have time for machines.
Some companies just don't appreciate the power of conversation.
Real people.
Mm-hmm.
It's like I'm calling the land of machines.
And with their robot voice.
Oh, I don't like those machines. Oh.
How can I help you?
Oh. I don't even remember.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Talk to a real person. Get the new IT card at discover.com.
You sure you can fit in there?
Around view monitor with bird's eye view.
Nice work.
Introducing the all-new Nissan Pathfinder. It's our most innovative Pathfinder ever. Nissan, innovation that excites.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Joe Matt-Maria with you here at the Discover Orange Bowl. Jimbo Fisher, remember, his team was a national title contender before they had that loss against NC State back in early October. They had risen as high as number three in the polls, and the way the defense is playing today and the consistency of E.J. Manuel, you get a sense of why everybody was so high on them. Dustin Hopkins, 88 career field goals made, and the chip shot moments ago to set the new standard in a place-kicking career in major college football. Set to kick off now with a two-touchdown lead over the MAC champion Huskies. Tommy Lee Lewis from the two. Lewis wrestled down at the 25.
Well, he was down.
And flag comes in at the end there.
Tommy Lee Lewis, they need to get the ball in his hands. They need to get him on the field offensively and get the ball in his hands in space. Now, I'm anxious to see what they're going to do here in the second half here, Tess, because he told us this week. As you see, he's down before that ball ever comes out.
And Carlos Williams put a little something extra into it.
Yeah, and Rod Carey, the head coach, told us.
Dead ball personal foul. Number 44, Northern Illinois. Half the distance to the goal. First and 10.
I'm going to get the special teamer, Perez Ford, there for Northern Illinois. So that'll back them up to the 13-yard line.
Yeah, what I was about to say is, you can't beat yourself, but Rod Carey said that he was going to save something for the second half, and they weren't going to hold back. And I'm curious to see how they're going to adjust now to this tight man coverage.
So we got about a half a dozen new formations. Going to bring out some new stuff for the second half. Here's Jordan Lynch, and a flag comes in there. Looked like motion.
Lynch has not had an easy night here tonight. They've been all over him.
False start. Number 10 of the offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Tried to force that offense of Lynch running against the middle of that defense. Remember, 11 straight games with at least 100 yards coming in. That's the single season record for a quarterback, but only 24 yards rushing tonight against the Norris. So first and 15. Lynch, they go with the screen here. A little tunnel for Perez Ashford, and he is driven back by Vince Williams, Christian Jones in the mix.
He is dominated. That offense is dominated. Remember, at the start of the game, we talked about what this Florida State team had to do. We said they had to establish their athletic superiority, and they've done that here tonight. And then the other thing we said is they have to punish and dominate Jordan Lynch. And Tess, they've done just that.
Checklist on Millen's game plan is being filled out. Second and 15, and that was low. Looking for the guy that you said needs to be involved more, Tommy Lee Lewis.
Yeah, that's the kid. Now, that guy, he's got some make you missing him. And if you can get him in space, and this is what I'm talking about. This isn't space. They get him, the ball's out, he anticipates it nice, but it's behind him. I mean, that's, Jordan Lynch has not brought his A game thus far.
Florida State defense has. As they press up at the line, only bring four, it's all they need with those athletes. And Lynch finds him in stride. It's Akeem Daniels. Boy, did they need that. Daniels makes it all the way to the 37-yard line.
Tess, you mentioned it earlier, and you said that they were going to change up their combinations in terms of route runners and stuff. Akeem Daniels is a running back, but he also used to be a wide receiver. And so they put him on the outside against Christian Jones, and he wins that battle. And that time, Jordan Lynch was dead on.
Played a year at receiver before coming back to running back. And he's a Florida native down here in the Orange Bowl. And now Lynch. Able to get to the edge that time.
He picked up something out of nothing because he was looking for that bubble screen on the top side, and it wasn't there. And then he pulled it down. Now we have Jernigan. It looks like he may be down, and that's a big blow if he's out of there, because that's a powerful man inside.
Yeah, he leads all the defensive tackles in tackles for Florida State. Second team all ACC, Timmy Jernigan. They tend to him. We'll take a break.
What's better, faster or slower?
Faster!
Yeah, what's fast?
My mom's car and a cheetah.
Okay.
A spaceship.
Spaceship. And what's slow?
My grandma's slow.
Would you like her better if she was fast?
I bet she would like it if she was fast.
Maybe give her some turbo boosters.
Tape a cheetah to her back?
Tape a cheetah to her back. Seems like you've thought about this before.
It's not complicated. Faster is better. And iPhone 5 downloads fastest on AT&T 4G.
Wouldn't it be cool if we took the already great Sentra apart and completely reimagined it with best-in-class combined MPG and more interior room than Corolla and Civic, and a technology suite with Bluetooth, navigation, and other handy stuff? Yeah, that would be cool. Introducing the all-new Nissan Sentra. It's our most innovative Sentra ever. Nissan, innovation that excites. Now get a $169 per month lease on a 2013 Nissan Sentra.
I'm snow, and just like you, the further in the winter we go, the heavier I get. And while your pants struggle to support the heavier you, your roof struggles to support the heavier me.
And your cut rate insurance might not pay for this, so get Allstate. You can save money and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Mayhem is everywhere, so get an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
Hey.
Who's that?
Oh, that's Rob.
When I lived in this apartment, the 49ers won the Super Bowl. I used to watch every game from this exact spot. This exact spot. I didn't know what else to do. This is my lucky seat, man. The team needs me, man.
Bud Light, for the fans who do whatever it takes.
The Discover Orange Bowl is brought to you by AT&T, official sponsor of the Bowl Championship Series. Nissan, tweet hashtag Nissan Heisman House for a chance to appear in next year's Heisman House. Allstate, Allstate is a proud sponsor of the Allstate Sugar Bowl. Are you in good hands? And Tostitos, where there's Tostitos, there's a party.
Husky fans looking for something here. They had that 55-yard reception by Akeem Daniels moments ago on 3rd and 15. And that gave him a bit of life. Trailing the Noles by 2 touchdowns early here in the second half. 2nd and 6 now. Jordan Lynch to pass. And now he'll tuck it, run it, first down, a lot more. And you see what he can do with a bit of open space as he lowers his shoulder to the 11-yard line.
There's a little maction. Jordan Lynch is going to have to learn to get down, because you're not going to last very long. You're trying to be a fullback in a quarterback spot.
Just not his style. Burrow playing tackle football on the streets of South Side of Chicago, running into cars. Here's Lynch now. Over the middle, gets it complete. Martell Moore, touchdown, Northern Illinois.
That's a big score right there. to big score for the Huskies at a lot of levels, the least of which is, hey, they know that's they drove the field to that one. Big play on the outside to Daniels, and then they're able to come back inside to their number one guy. Did you see the pick, Tess? That's exactly what I was expecting. Martell Moore with that pick on the inside, and he's able to pick up six.
And Sims adds the extra point. We got a touchdown ball game here. Northern Illinois has found their offense. Martell Moore, the 11-yard touchdown reception. Dave Doran, the former coach, enjoying things from the stands.
Edmunds.com says the all-new Nissan Altima is a better car than Camry. To argue would be rude. Nissan Altima, with moving object detection. Lease now, just $199 per month. Visit ChooseNissan.com. Road and Track called Sentra an economy car, minus the look and feel of an economy car. Wonder how Civic and Corolla look and feel about that. The all-new Nissan Sentra, with best-in-class MPG. Lease for $169 per month. Visit ChooseNissan.com.
Millions of women are devoted mothers. But not many have to juggle five kids. Even fewer try to deal with all that stress by skating through life. All while rolling with the punches. I don't care. I'm Jen Mayfield, and I'm one of a kind.
Shocking sensation of being on a business trip where everything goes right, backed by a 100% satisfaction guarantee. Feel the advantage. Feel the Hamptonality.
Road closed?
There's a guy. Excuse me, Glacier Point?
Follow me!
Follow me! Keep up, keep up, keep up.
Look, he's right there!
Crystal Falls?
Introducing the all-new Nissan Pathfinder. Nissan, innovation that excites.
Told you in the first half they're going to have to make some adjustments. Here's the adjustment. Watch the pick on the inside. With that pick, that allows him to get across, and it's a kind of a combination coverage in the backside, but Moore gets on top of the safety. Lynch, because he has enough time, is able to make that throw before he takes a whack. That's really well done in the pick department.
He's thrown down by Tyler Hunter there at the end of the play, and Jordan Lynch. Man, oh man, they were facing that third and 15 back at the 8-yard line, and Akeem Daniels is going down the near sideline, hauled in the 55-yard reception, and we got an onside kick here, and Northern Illinois pulled it off. They roll the dice again, and they come up winners. Fake punt the first half, onside kick here in the third quarter. Harris Logan secured it. Oh, Cinderella's dreaming a bit here in the second half, aren't they, Matt?
And Rod Carey, I'll tell you what, that man, he's got some guts. That is outstanding.
Weedle, the kicker, placed it perfectly, too.
That's a great job. It went past the mandatory 10 yards, and they caught him completely off guard because you saw the Garnet and Gold dropping, and that's exactly what they were counting on, and they were able to create that pocket and sets up this big first down.
Empty set now. Lynch ball is batted and falls incomplete. Rod Carey coaching his first game as a head coach. told us, hey, I got some things I'm saving for the second half. This is a guy that was an offensive line coach at Illinois State and North Dakota, and the offensive line coach at Northern Illinois when the year started. And then a week into the year, Mike Dunbar was the offensive coordinator, left the team battling cancer. He was elevated to offensive coordinator. And then the day they find out they're going to the BCS, head coach. The end around this time, Tommy Lee Lewis, and it'll be third and short for the Huskies.
I got to tell you, I'm impressed with the coaching job by Rod Carey and his staff and what he's been able to do. Yes, he's been undermanned, and he knew that going into it. And they took it full force, but he also knew what he has, and he knows his team tests. And that's a big piece of the puzzle when you're dealing with these kids. He knows what his team's about, and that's why he's taking the chances that he's taking.
Third and two after the successful onside kick. They go with that jumbo backfield here, and Lynch is going to try to pick it up, and Lynch is able to get it. So they move the chains.
Can you see it, Tess? You can see they're starting to get a little bit of confidence. They're starting to believe that they can play with this Florida State team. The whole thing is precipitated by that man right there. With those gutsy calls, he's given them that belief.
They brought Ken Bishop into the game on that last play. The 300-pound defensive tackle was lead blocking for Jordan Lynch. Lynch to pass now on first down. And it's off the hands of Martell Moore. Could have had something there.
He needed to. He had Kelvin Smith beat. He got on top of him, but it was thrown behind him again. Hasn't had a real accurate day here. That last drive, he was superb. He's got to be more consistent in this game because there's some opportunities that he can't miss, and he has missed them.
Florida State defense have been stellar up until that last drive. Let's see if they can lock in here on Lynch. Designed quarterback run.
Oh,
and he
man.
Was met that time and thrown back by Telvin Smith. Telvin Smith has done that a few times tonight.
Telvin Smith is one good-looking rascal, and he can run. He's about 6'3", about 215 pounds. He can flat out run, but I'll tell you what, he's not afraid to run into things out there. And either is Jordan Lynch. That kid's tough. Southside Chicago, the baddest part of town.
Third and six as Lynch checks over the defensive set. Looks towards Rod Carey, remember, former offensive coordinator, now the head coach, calling plays from the sideline. Bob pulls upstairs to help him find his way tonight. Play clock down to three. Third and six. Lynch got it complete. Just extended the play and found Tommy Lee Lewis.
That's just a great play by Jordan Lynch because clearly this defense was getting after him. Is that 22? 27. That's Xavier Rhodes, their corner, who's just played a great game here tonight. He's locked guys down in the backfield.
He's their best cover corner. He is a shutdown corner for Florida State. First team all ACC. Gives them some veteran leadership in the defensive backfield. And you can see the medical staff now turning him over. He went down at the end of the play, matched up with Moore.
Yeah, he's a big corner, too. I mean, he's 6'2". And a little jostling going on down there. Ooh, I don't know what happened there. He and Martell Moore were getting after each other. They're letting them play, which I like to see. He must have landed wrong or something on that knee. Lost in all that. Yes. Jordan Lynch on that one extended the play. Clearly, the defensive line of Florida State was winning up front, but he bought time with his feet and was able to find that.
Look at that scene over on the bench of Northern Illinois and the 1,300 students that took the 24-and-a-half-hour sponsored bus drive. 26 buses came down from DeKalb. We're starting to believe a little bit. Trailing by seven here halfway through the third quarter. promising Wells now, and he can only get a yard on that end around.
You know, when they do have any kind of success in the run game, which hasn't been very much, that guy right there, 87, Scheffler, 275 pounds. He's a blocking Jesse, man. That guy will get after you. Not afraid to mix it up with anybody. Has pretty good confidence in himself. This was his lone choice to come here, and he's a tough sucker.
Well, his ACL twice in the last 18 months on his return to the field, Jason Scheffler. Second and nine. Little tunnel screen that time was shut down right away by Bjorn Warner. Bjorn Warner able to find Tommy Lee Lewis.
And he was able to find him because he had great awareness. Tess, he felt that. And so he wasn't getting aggressively blocked right in the start. So he just went off, ran underneath. Scheffler, he's not afraid of anybody out there. Big third down here, Tess.
Third down and eight, empty set for Jordan Lynch. Two receivers to the top, three to the near, including Tommy Lee Lewis in the slot.
That Jameson Wells is a guy who moves the chains down the bottom of your screen.
Look at the time Lynch has all of a sudden. And it is picked off. Terrence Brooks comes up big for the Noles. Lynch had all kinds of time and then leaked out to the right, and Brooks jumped in front.
Poor decision by Jordan Lynch, but a big time play by Brooks. Stayed on his coverage. Whenever you start to get a guy start getting into the corner, you tighten things up. There's a small window to throw into. As he rolls to his right, you just plaster. You plaster your guy, and that's exactly what he did. Plastering is just playing really tight man-to-man.
Take that trade off anytime. Terrence Brooks with the interception. Last year's bowl win against Notre Dame, he had a key late interception against Tommy Reese. And Rod Carey, he knows, oh, that was a missed opportunity. The onside kick, moving the chains, starting to gain some momentum.
Joe, at the least right there, he needed to have some awareness to throw that ball away so they at least could try a field goal.
Reminder, Wednesday night on ESPN, it's the All-State Sugar Bowl. Louisville and Florida coverage begins Wednesday night, 8 o'clock on ESPN. We will see how Teddy Bridgewater fares against that Florida defense. Manuel now. He's going to check down to Devontae Freeman, and Freeman able to get that edge and gain 8 yards.
If I'm Florida State right now, got to settle myself down. I'd go back to running the football inside. They have that offensive line has dominated that front all night long. So let them go do what they do best. And offensive linemen, they love to come off the ball and move people out of the way.
Trey Jackson settling in next to Brian Stork, center. Keep it on the ground on second and one, and look at Devontae Freeman just hit that gear and get out to the 47-yard line. It's met by Victor Jacques, the middle linebacker for Northern Illinois from right here in Miami. Played his high school football at Columbus High here in Miami. In fact, he got a tattoo of the Miami skyline and the Orange Bowl logo. You see it there on his left shoulder and bicep. In his return home, proud to show it off all week long anywhere Jacques went. Pulled up that sleeve and said, I'm home and I'm playing in the Orange Bowl. DJ Manuel, and that is incomplete as it was a strike downfield for Green, but Jimmy Ward had coverage.
Sean Green has had himself a big night here tonight. And EJ Manuel has been able to find him because, again, excellent protection. But this ball is thrown behind just a tad, and that allows Jimmy Ward to be able to close on that thing.
stop from his defense. Second and 10. Screen set up for Freeman. Blockers in front. Cuts to the inside of them. Little bit of traffic, and he almost got free of it, but he's taken down at the 48.
I'll tell you who hustled his rear end off, and that was Ken Bishop. You talked about him earlier. The defensive lineman, they bring him in sometimes as a fullback. He's got some size to him. Got about 310 pounds of him, but he got on his horse that one. He got on out to the outside, was able to force part of that play. Big third down here again. Haven't been good in third down here in this game.
Third and 5. Going to take a shot downfield on third and 5. And Green beyond him and to the outside. So Florida State, another third down conversion that they can't come up with it. Great views tonight with a DirecTV Ultimate picture cam. Here's another one.
He knew where he wanted to go right away. Was on the, he had that matchup on the outside against Rashawn Melvin on the on down here in the side. Melvin plays it perfectly. Green goes up, but not quite there.
Matt, with the success that this offensive line
I'm surprised.
Driving the defense off the field. Why take a shot like that?
Yeah, I'm surprised. I would be pounding the football right here.
Instead, they punt away. First spin here as it's fair caught by Sebastiano right near the 10-yard line. Well, that Florida State defense, they will be back out there. Yorn Warner and company facing Jordan Lynch when we return to South Florida.
This is the best
view high above Sun Life Stadium. Air coverage provided by Goodyear. Tires that go the distance make Goodyear a fan favorite. Goodyear, more driven. Joe Tessitore alongside Matt Millen. Reporting down on the field tonight is Maria Taylor. Got ourselves a one possession game here in the Discover Orange Bowl. Jordan Lynch, well beyond Perez Ashford. Nick Wasom had coverage there. BCS busters in recent years. We've gotten used to the TCUs and Boise's and Utah and coming up with wins. Non-AQs, not automatic qualifying schools, have won their last three appearances in the BCS game. But this is a much different beast. This is a Mid-American conference team with a loss. Those are all undefeated teams that are now in bigger conferences or established national powers. This is a Northern Illinois team. It's David versus Goliath. As they go with the wide receiver screen out to the 17, Tommy Lee Lewis. You know the history you've seen. Obviously Utah, the thriller, the all-time thriller with Boise and Oklahoma back in the Fiesta Bowl. Of course, they played each other, didn't BCS Busters, Boise and TCU in 09. And then the Rose Bowl victory by TCU. But, you know, Pac-12 team now, Utah, Big 12 team now, TCU, Boise, an established power. Northern Illinois trying to do the same here against the ACC champs. Third and 4, and it's incomplete as he was looking for Akeem Daniels.
Yeah, because they brought pressure right off the edge. And Tyler Hunter, number 1, strong safety, he gets a clean shot. Now, he's got to feel this, but he's got to be more accurate with this ball because he has a chance if he makes that throw to Daniels underneath. Hey, the guy who's played a heck of a game here tonight has been Christian Jones. Between he and Vince Williams, they have made a ton of plays here tonight.
Sixth time that it's a 3-and-out. That Knowles defense has been superb and near punts away. Kenny Shaw with the fair catch. BCS on ESPN is available live anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, smartphone at watchespn.com and with the Watch ESPN app. Tomorrow night, All-State Sugar Bowl, Louisville, Florida. Thursday, we got the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, Oregon and K-State.
Test, they need to start pounding the football.
They go with the reverse, and it's Greg Dent And Northern Illinois did a very nice job of pursuing that. It was Sean Evans staying at home at that corner spot.
That was a big time play by Sean Evans, because not only did he hold outside leverage, he worked off a block, and then he was able to recover and come back and make the play. That's really well done by Evans.
Team Daniels being coached up, as you see Rod Carey taking a walk over to discuss things with the offensive line.
Numbers in the box right now work against Florida State.
Option to the near side on second and nine. The pitch goes to Wilder Jr., and it'll be a third down here. Oh, flag comes in. You saw Joe Windsor come in, and this is going to be a 15-yarder against the Huskies.
Windsor played it extremely well. His helmet came flying off. But see, I mentioned numbers on the front end. Jamal Bass, number six, got in there also. I mentioned numbers on the front end. The way
after the
to
play, personal foul, get out of bounds, number six, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Yeah. Just can't do that if you want to stay in this.
The way to even those numbers up is to run the option, because now you have to account. And right there at the end, that last thing by Bass, that was not needed. Uncalled for, good call. But when you run the option test, you take an extra guy who's not accounted for, the quarterback, and now you have to account for him, and so it evens the numbers up. And having said that, Northern Illinois played it extremely well until the end.
Would have been a third and medium. Instead, it's a first down at the 42 for Florida State. Here's Wilder Jr. again, and this time he is met. Tries to drive ahead for an extra yard, but it was Tyrone Clark coming up to get a piece of it.
I would keep on pounding it. I would keep on pounding it and let this offensive line, Irvin, number 75, Matias, number 70. You got Stork on the inside, Trey Jackson, the right guard, Menelik Watson. Those are big, powerful men. They're all athletic. Let them just wear on this defensive front.
They're going to pass on second and seven. And they get it complete. And what a nice move that time. Just hesitating for a moment was Kenny Shaw. Gave one little move and then accelerated. And first great down, Florida State.
Yeah, and great balance test. Because after he got hit, he had right here. You're watching the hit. Now watch his balance right there. He's able to keep his feet and then to make you miss on Bass, and he picks up more. That's really nice right there.
Slippery was Kenny Shaw. And a first down just outside the 25. And that was off the mark as they tried to bubble it for Christian Green. Just loop him out there. Emmanuel went high. 37. Pass attempts, 38 pass attempts now already for E.J. Manuel.
E.J. Manuel's season, I think if you wanted to put one word on him that summed him up, it would be inconsistent. There were times when he was just absolutely outstanding, and there were other times when you scratched your head. E.J. Manuel has a chance to be a pretty good player. He's got to get more consistent.
Jr. again out of the I formation. Remember, E.J. Manuel has revealed recently that this season he's been distracted a bit with things going on at home. Mom Jackie unable to make the trip down here. She had her eighth chemo treatment yesterday, battling breast cancer. His father Eric is here tonight, so that has been weighing heavily on him all season long. Jackie was on the field for senior day pregame ceremony. Very emotional day for E.J. Manuel. Now looking to wrap up his college career here with an Orange Bowl championship.
Spread him out here on third and seven, Tess.
Felt the pressure, tucks it, runs it, picks up the first down, put the ball in his left hand, and they will have the first down thanks to the legs of the big 6'5" long striding E.J. Manuel.
And so they took away the throws down the field. They were only rushing four, and Manuel was able to find that lane and take advantage of it. You mentioned it, his legs. This is an accomplished runner. This guy can really go, too. He's a big kid, 250 pounds. He's 6'6".
That
he's legit.
The third quarter.
Northern Illinois showed a little life there in the third quarter. But Florida State marches on. It'll be first and goal when we start the fourth quarter here in the Discover Orange Bowl.
Discover card.
I want to ask you a couple of questions.
I've got nothing to hide.
My bill is due today and I haven't paid yet.
Is that a confession?
Have I committed a crime?
Nope. Actually, with our new card, you can pay up till midnight online or by phone.
It's going to be great.
Discover Orange Bowl. Ready for fourth quarter action with Florida State holding Northern Illinois to 10 points. 17-10 lead. That Northern Illinois team that scores over 40 a game. Florida State and EJ Manuel looking to add to their cushion here to start the fourth quarter. Here's Manuel taking it himself and right in. Great way to start the fourth quarter for Florida State. No surprise, Tess.
What they did is just let that offensive line get man on man, and then they gained the extra man by using Manuel as the runner. The runner then becomes the fullback and the blocker. It's just a lead. It's a power lead, but I want you to watch up front. Look at that by Urban. Now Trey Jackson comes around. Wilder with the block. I mean, it doesn't get any better than that. That's just pure man-on-man dominance.
Back home in Virginia Beach, you know there's a smile on the face of Mom Jackie. E.J. Manuel pushes it back to a two-touchdown margin.
All right, if you're thinking about...
E.J. Manuel stretching out there after that touchdown run moments ago. Remember, he started his career as a Gator Bowl MVP and went over West Virginia at Heroics in the Chick-fil-A Bowl. The last to top Notre Dame a year ago. And here looking to cap his career in the Discover Orange Bowl. 24-10 lead for the ACC champs. Tommy Lee Lewis will have a chance here from the 7. And out past the 30. Maria.
Guys, I just overheard Rod Carey addressing his team, telling them that they can withstand this initial punch and also that they're about to find out what they're made of in this play, guys. So he's really trying to urge his team on, keep them motivated and inspired in this game.
Yeah, Maria, as you well know in talking to Rod Carey this week, he's done a good job of delivering the message to his team. Something to be said for calling yourself a champion. They are the Mid-American Conference champions. They have a lot of confidence, but in a two-touchdown hole here. And keep in mind, a lot of people criticize whether or not they deserve to even be here. Could they compete? Weakest schedule in college football this year, Northern Illinois. Of course, they won 12 straight, did what they had to do, won 21 of their last 22 games. Had the victory in the MAC championship game, and the system was set up, the rules were written to have them here in Irvine. Second down.
They're not playing like they got the easiest schedule in the FBS. They're playing good, tough football. They're getting beat at the line of scrimmage, and they've wasted some opportunities. They were down at the 23-yard line. They threw the pick. And then there's been a couple times when Lynch has been off when they've had guys open, and then other times the receivers have dropped the ball.
Third and 8 now for Lynch. Trying to keep things alive here. And that ball was caught by Perez Ashford. Hard to believe he came up with it. but they'll move the chains.
What a nice window Lynch threw that one into. On the run, scrambling for his life. Watch the ball, the only place it can be. That is beautiful. And a great job of keeping your feet down on the outside there. That's as good as it gets by Ashford. A lot of time.
And finally met. As Demonte McAllister ran in to Jordan Lynch.
He ran right into him.
He's also flipping his way right off, McAllister. That is the first sack that we've had tonight, as well as the defensive line has played. First sack of the night. Second and 12. Lynch hoping for the best here and then throwing it away. Pressure came from the All-American Jorn Werner. Big German went back for the holidays to Germany.
Well, one of the things, when you're getting tight coverage, you have to anticipate. Now here they're just playing a zone, and you can see the coverage that everybody, there's somebody around except for that on the outside. And so when you're getting that type of tight coverage, you have to start anticipating and throwing the ball to spots.
Third and 12. Remember that interception on third down last go round after the onside kick and a bit of momentum. Incomplete. And a flag comes in.
Ooh, I don't know about that.
Breskison was shielded that time by Carlos Williams. And the flag comes in.
That was some pretty darn good coverage. He took away the inside, gave him one way to go. And then Williams is on the outside. And that
pass interference. Number nine, defense. Ball be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Well, Jimbo Fisher not too pleased with that one. See how he takes the inside away, gets the hand on. He's fine right there. He started the tackle before.
So
that's
that
why
right
they called it.
Arm,
good call.
Shoulder coming and make contact there. So fresh set of downs. He's trying to find a streaking Martell Moore, who was well covered that time.
Yeah, they've tried Martell Moore all night long down the sideline. And Xavier Rhodes has been all over. The only success that he's had has been on inside routes. They need to go back to the pick routes. I'm surprised they haven't done that.
And around with Daniels, and Daniels will be about a yard and a half shy of the line to make. It'll be third and short from just beyond the 40-yard line.
I talk about picks. There's a lot of things you can do. You can line up in stack formations. You can line up in bunch formations. Anything that makes a man defender have to back off a little bit, it gives you the advantage back to the offense. Big third and one and a half here, Tess.
Luke Ekus, number 83, often a lead blocker for Jordan Lynch in spots like this, and that's exactly what he does here. It'll depend on the mark, as Vince Williams did a good job of corralling Jordan Lynch.
Yeah, he came from inside out. He's been enjoying not being touched because his defensive line has played so well. Watch him come inside out. That is really nice.
In case Vince Williams ever wants to be a chiropractor, he got a good start right there on Jordan Lynch's neck.
Big man. So Ken Bishop, number 93, the 310-pound defensive tackle. Just looking right there with the dreads. That's a big, powerful man. Follow that rear end.
Huh. It'll pave the way. Ken Bishop, the defensive tackle, comes in to play fullback. Full house diamond formation, and now Daniels comes in motion on fourth and inches. Lynch, did he get there?
Depends which foot, right or left foot.
Now the near side official came in.
That looks like a first. According to our yellow line, we're pretty accurate, but line. Yeah, but we're not dead on.
So they will measure here as Lynch tried to inch his way towards that line and went right behind his defensive tackle coming in.
That's nicely done by Bishop. He planted him. And then that's a good effort by Jordan Lynch because he powered his way through. Didn't get a lot of help up front in terms of getting movement, but he got enough to get the first.
It's a first down.
It's a big first down.
Kent Bishop, who actually started both at fullback on offense and at defensive tackle in the MAC championship game. He helps pave the way here.
He moves well, Tess.
He's staying in the game here on first down. Daniels once again comes in motion. And once again, they go with Lynch. And he is tripped up right near the line of scrimmage. That was Terrence Brooks, who had that key interception in the third quarter, coming up to make the tackle on Jordan Lynch.
Hey, the guy, Brooksy's had himself a nice game here tonight. I mentioned earlier, Christian Jones, number 7, and Vince Williams on the inside. Those two have played a really outstanding game. Vince Williams, man, he's made plays all over the field tonight.
Second and 9. They go with the pitch on the end around to Ron Brown, chased down in the backfield. Ball came loose, and it is still on the ground, and then finally they fall on it. That was Xavier Rhodes. That was just a disaster of a play for Northern Illinois. The ball came loose when he got hit. They're going to check to see if he was down, but Nick Moody came in and just leveled DeRon Brown. Watch Moody come in at the end of this play. Knee down? Yes.
Yeah, he's down.
And then Moody just came in with that big hit that dislodged the ball, but they will clearly take a look here.
Yeah, that's Xavier Rhodes also. Moody comes in and hits his knees down.
On the field was a fumble recovered by Florida State. The previous play is under further review.
They'll be looking for that indisputable video evidence.
What they'll be looking for is to see if he still had control of the ball.
For now, it's a Florida State fumble recovery. We'll take a break as they take a peek.
Regular appetizers, you'd be sharing them by now. Taco Bell's new Loaded Grillers. Appetizer taste of spicy wings, tasty skins, and beefy nachos. Each just 99 cents and wrapped up just for you.
Discover card.
I asked my husband to pay our bill and he forgot.
Yeah, I've got one like that
too, but you have the new IT card and it's your first time making a payment, so there's no late fee. Really?
Yep. You don't even have to ask.
And we'll never raise your APR for paying late either.
Oh, that's great. So,
is your husband off the hook?
No.
He went out for milk last week and came back with a puppy.
Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it.
Well, forgiveness is a wonderful thing. Yeah.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Late payment forgiveness. Get the new IT card at discover.com.
Ever ask somebody to lend you a foot? Who thinks about stuff like that? Vince Mahe grew up on two continents and noticed that wherever you go, people have their hands full, but their feet free. The result? A liftgate you operate with your foot. Codename?
Open Sesame!
The all-new 2013 Ford Escape. It's what happens when you go further.
This is the world of today's PC. A dark age where imagination has been banished and shapeless, gray designs have remained unchanged for decades. But now, we have the freedom to choose a different kind of personal computer. One with breakthrough touchscreen technology, sleek all-in-one design, and brilliant HD picture. The PC, reimagined by Vizio.
The Discover Orange Bowl is brought to you by the new Discover It Card. Finally, a credit card that's changing the game. The new 2013 Ford F-150 with EcoBoost. Vizio, ranked highest in customer satisfaction with HD TVs by J.D. Power and Associates. And Taco Bell, sometimes you gotta live Mas.
Moments ago, Ben Oldham, the SEC crew replay official, confirmed the call on the field. A fumble and a recovery by Florida State.
And what they would be looking is, does his knee come down before the ball starts moving? And right there, the ball starts moving just as he's going down. Right there, it starts to move. Then the knee comes, that's awful close. I mean, it's really close.
And considering that the call on the field was fumble, they would need to have that indisputable video evidence to get a reversal. So first down for the Noles, and Freeman upended at about the 37-yard line. That was Jimmy Ward coming in to make the tackle.
This is what I would have been doing from the middle of the second quarter.
How about all night long?
Yeah.
That advantage of power up front.
Yeah. James Coley, their offensive coordinator, he's gone to throwing with, and for good reason. I mean, he has all kinds of time, so you can make some throws, but nothing gets an offense in the mood more than a tough running game.
Ronnie Pryor from the fullback position. Pryor, second of the game. They motioned out Freeman, and Pryor just shredded him right up the middle
because his offensive line just mauled people up front. Watch Matias, 70, Stork, 52. Irvin on the left side, 75. That's really well blocked. And then once Pryor gets to the second level, the safeties are out of there, so it's just nothing but green in between. Pryor's got himself over 100 yards, about a buck 30.
On four carries.
Not a bad night.
First 100-yard rushing game for the senior, Lonnie Pryor. Northern Illinois was trying to get back in this game, but the Noles defense just kept coming and coming. The turnover and then the quick score.
Sick of this thing popping up.
I know. Cable's more annoying than...
I shouldn't have to stop watching a show or cancel a recording.
Cable's worse than... Totally. You need to upgrade to DirecTV and get the new Genie. She lets you record 5 shows at once.
Wow. DirecTV is better than...
Salsa. They need more salsa at table 5.
Waiter.
You mean the Ottoman?
Yeah.
Aerial coverage of the Discover Orange Bowl is provided by Goodyear Tires that go the distance, make Goodyear a fan favorite. Goodyear, more driven. Lonnie Pryor has been driven. You can see it coming all week long from the senior fullback for Florida State.
He's fired up the other day, wasn't he, Tess?
And we were down at the luncheon down in Miami. I was talking to Lonnie before we went up on stage, set to interview him. And he was like a prize fighter getting ready for a ring walk. He wanted to get his hands on Northern Illinois. And for anybody out there that thought, we heard some of this recently, that Florida State, how inspired would they be? You hang with this team the past week, they wanted this badly. They are looking to be called Orange Bowl champions. Tommy Lee Lewis will take a knee. Maria, what do you have for us?
Well, guys, you saw Pryor getting that touchdown run earlier, and he's had 2 so far. On his first run, they use an athlete tracking system here at Florida State that's able to actually judge their velocity and acceleration of the players, and the chip is placed in the pad. How about Pryor was going over 18 miles per hour on his first touchdown run? Guys, Florida State is actually putting a quantity on being athletic, so now we know exactly how fast they're racing up and down the field, guys.
He was impressive, Maria, in that 60-yard touchdown run and went for 37 yards just moments ago. They didn't quite have that stuff when you were an All-American at Penn State.
No, they just said, how fast are you? Faster than the rest of them. That's all that matters.
And up and over for 11 yards is Akeem Daniels. Let's take a look at tonight's Taco Bell touchdown spotlight. Lonnie Pryor.
Lonnie Pryor has enjoyed the benefit of having a nice offensive line, but and then once you get to the second level, it's got to be all you. And tonight, to the tune of 130 yards, it's been all him. The same thing that Akeem Daniels has not been able to enjoy on the other side.
See him reaching for his left knee there. Running back for Northern Illinois. He's going to go off slower, not at all.
You know, we've talked about this, Joe, at the start of the game. One of the game points that we talked about, and we've mentioned it before, is to establish their physical and athletic dominance. And he did. I mean, they've done it. To me personally, I would have gone to it a lot sooner with that offensive line and just keep on pounding the ball. I think Lonnie Pryor could have had his first 200-yard night.
Of course, are very talented in the backfield, but missing Chris Thompson, who's been out for the year since tearing an ACL. So Freeman, Wilder Jr., and Pryor have been carrying the load. Jordan Lynch finding more over the middle, and the hits continue from Telvin Smith. And there's a flag coming in from far away, well after the play.
Nice hit, too.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 22 of the defense, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
And you got Telvin for the 15-yarder. Show you what he did after this hit.
That's a nice play. Drives the shoulder through. Yeah, unless they thought that was a celebration of some sort. I must have missed it.
He's been hitting hard, but nothing like we saw at Jadeveon Clowney today from South Carolina.
No, and you can see when he gets up there, he's just happy about his tackle. Celebrate a little bit. Maybe they thought that was a little bit too much. Jadeveon Clowney's hit today was legendary.
We were on the DirecTV mobile studio bus. Nearly exploded the roof off that thing. Our reaction to watching Clowney today.
That was a great hit.
If nice you haven't seen it, you get all the coverage on SportsCenter coming up after the Discover Orange Bowl. But just a great day of action. Clowney was the supreme highlight of it all. Martell Moore is pushed back.
He's going to set up a third and four. Third and four. If you've noticed all night long, this Northern Illinois offense, they've had to throw a lot of quick stuff because they know that they don't match up well. Now, having said that, there's only been one sack here all night long. He's been getting the ball out quick, or he's been buying time by getting on the edge and dash like this.
Third and four, and that's incomplete. Threw it to the outside of Lewis. It would have been gobbled up by Smith even if he caught it.
You know, he hasn't had a very accurate night here tonight. And then at times when he's need to throw with touch, he's put too much mustard on it. Now he's going to go for it on fourth down, which they have to, down by 21.
Fourth and four, and Lynch gets it complete, but will they give him the forward progress? That linesman is going to mark him about a half a yard short as Tyler Hunter came up and was able to secure Perez Ashford and stop him from going forward.
Ashford came back to the ball, and I think in coming back to the ball, he lost track of where that first down marker was, and he's short.
So a turnover on downs, 8:41 to go. History made by Northern Illinois just being here. As for the BCS history of Florida State, go back to that great Sugar Bowl victory over Virginia Tech, winning a national championship Back then, of course, playing for the BCS National Championship was commonplace. But this, their first BCS appearance since 05. Fourth time in the Orange Bowl. The thriller against Penn State came in triple overtime, a 26-23 loss after the 05 season. So, you know, a lot of people just make the assumption, Florida State, BCS, no big deal. Trust me, very big deal to this program at this time. We heard it all week long from the Mat.
Yes, I got to tell you, I think what Jimbo Fisher's done down there in the last few years has been outstanding. He has gone back on the recruiting trail, and he has gotten himself some outstanding young players. He's got some guys in backup. He's got depth again. He's got skilled people. He has an outstanding offensive line. I think he's done a great job and put Florida State in a position to be a big-time player in the national championship race over the next few years.
Number 15,
Mario Edwards,
number one overall prospect in the country last year, and there are many like him coming on board to Tallahassee. And Wilder takes it ahead to the 46. Another recruiting class coming up this February. See the top names set to join. ESPN recruiting rank right now is number 11. Of course, winning the Orange Bowl helps out with the geographic base of recruiting. So many Noles come from the South Florida area. Jimbo Fisher just stockpiling talent, especially, man, you look at that defensive line. Name after name. I mean, they lost a couple guys this year, Tank Carradine and All-American Brandon Jenkins, and they can backfill with other top prospects.
Yeah, that's what I said. His depth is back. And then when you couple that with this offensive line returning, I mean, they could return every guy, and they should. I mean, Menelik Watson, who just walked off injured, he needs to come back. He needs more seasoning. On the other side, you got the same thing. With the big offensive tackle, Cameron Irving. This is going to be a dominant offensive line.
Third and six. And Manuel was met that time and driven back by Ken Bishop. Saw Ken Bishop play some fullback, and now you see him at defensive tackle.
I got to tell you, no quit. There's no quit in this Husky defense. They've been outmanned a little bit up front by this offensive line, but they've showed up when they've had to. You can just see old Bishop on the inside holding a point and putting his face right in there. And that, of course, is our ultimate picture cam by DirecTV, the ultimate picture cam. And it's courtesy of our friends at DirecTV.
Who knew you had play-by-play hosting in you? Jason Beatty comes on to punt here. Six and a half minutes.
I need a card, my friend.
Left in this game. Sebastiano brings it out to the 13-yard line. Now, more the score that people thought we would see. 31-10 Florida State, but we had a game for three quarters, didn't we?
Yeah, outstanding.
Shoot, I missed a payment.
Discover card.
I missed a payment.
Oh, shoot.
Shoot, this is bad, isn't it?
Oh, no, we're good.
This is your first time missing a payment.
And you've got our new card, so we don't
charge you a late fee for that.
Plus, we won't hike up your APR for paying late either.
Man, that's great.
It is great, man.
Thank you.
Well, thanks for your help.
Yeah, no problem. Call back anytime.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Late payment forgiveness. Get the new IT card at discover.com.
My insurance rates are probably going to double.
But, Dad, you've got
Allstate. With accident forgiveness, they guarantee your rates won't go up just because of an accident.
Smart kid.
Indeed. Are you in good hands?
What's better, doing two things at once or just one?
Two!
You sure?
I am absolutely positive.
Two times is awesome. The thing I can do is wave my head and wave.
That's amazing. I've never seen anything like that.
Look, I can do it.
Hold on, I'm watching this.
I'm getting dizzy.
It's not complicated. Doing two things at once is better. And only AT&T's network lets you talk and surf on your iPhone 5.
Why is everybody in such a hurry? Because it's the final 100 hours of the Ford year-end celebration. Last chance to get the best deals of the year on America's freshest lineup. Hurry in for the great mileage. Hurry in for the latest technology. The clock is ticking, so hurry to the final 100 hours of Ford's year-end celebration before everything's gone. And one more thing, hurry.
Get a Focus with 2,000 cash plus 500 year-end bonus cash with no charge, sync, and sound during the final 100 hours of the Ford year-end celebration. Only at your local Ford dealer.
So, you say men are superior drivers?
Yeah.
Then how do I get this
safe driving bonus check? Every 6 months without an accident, Allstate sends a check. Okay. Silence. Are you in good hands?
Down here in South Florida, they put Flipper to work in more ways than one, like trying to pick major football games. And do you know that Flipper picked Notre Dame to win the Discover BCS National Championship?
Well, what's his record?
And we got to get that. We got to get that research done there, Millen. Of course, Notre Dame and Alabama, number one and number two on this magnificent field. Looks like a putting green at Augusta that they put in place for the Discover Orange Bowl in the national championship game. BCS coming up next Monday. The Irish, the Tide, unbeaten number one, mighty offensive line of Alabama, and Nick Saban. Will the dynasty continue? A.J. McCarron meeting up with Manti Te'o, the Heisman finalist. That's next Monday at 8 o'clock on ESPN. Jordan Lynch himself finishing seventh for the Heisman Trophy. Able to connect here to Moore, and a flag comes in at the end of that play.
Yeah, I think Jordan Lynch is going to go back and watch this game, and he's going to be disappointed, because certainly he's got the grit, the toughness, all those things, and he, you know, his mettle to run the football is fine, but in the passing department, he's going to be disappointed with some of his decisions.
Number 10 of the offense, half the distance to the goal, remains second down.
Yeah, that means they got caught by a pick, like Tommy Lee Lewis.
Just like they said they would all second half.
Which I thought they'd do more of, Tess, to be honest with you. And, you know, you don't have, you can't be blatant about running your picks and rubs and all that kind of stuff. A lot of times a pick is no more than getting in the way and making the defender go around you.
Checking down over the middle to Jamison Wells, but he couldn't hold on.
Yeah, you got to have a little bit more time. You can't put so much mustard on that throw right there. That's the part.
He's done a bit of that tonight.
Yes, he's
muscled the ball tonight. Jordan Lynch, who had such an outstanding season, second team All-America by the AP, led the nation in total yards, over 4,700. Now this Florida State defense, that is just a different animal. And a flag comes in there as you saw them get an early jump, and you see the speed for a moment of Tommy Lee Lewis.
I like that kid.
Tommy Lee Lewis, just 5'7", 155. Down here in South Florida. That's Ronald Darby, the cornerback, freshman quarterback from Maryland for Florida State, who was named the ACC's Defensive Rookie of the Year. You know, it's interesting. He was a big recruit a year ago, Matt. Florida State defeated Notre Dame in the bowl game up in Orlando. Last time Notre Dame lost. And he was originally committed to Notre Dame, Ronald Darby. And this is a player as a true freshman cornerback. Get the call here.
On the defense, that penalty is declined. Got a personal foul, roughing the passer. Number 51 of the defense, that 15-yard penalty will go from the end of the run. First down.
As they tend to Darby, the medical staff. This is a player that Notre Dame could have used with the injuries they had at cornerback. He was originally committed to Notre Dame, switched to Florida State before signing day. We invite you to stay tuned for the Ford BCS postgame show. That's coming up right after the game. We will announce the MVP of the trophy presentation with Mark Jones, who's joined us here in South Florida, and recap things with a Discover Orange Bowl.
Old Lonnie Pryor had himself a really good game individually. E.J. Manuels played himself a pretty good game. Rashad Green on the outside, that defensive line. There's a couple guys
you can put pats on the back to. I'll tell you, the, Vince Williams in the middle. There's another flag down here.
And I think this may be a bench violation over there, and you can see how heated Jimbo Fisher is.
Yeah, he's.
And now Matt Moore. Listen here.
Unsportsmanlike conduct from the head coach. 15-yard penalty.
Oh, they're getting Jimbo for 15 yards here. Let's see here with Jimbo Fisher. And that exchange.
That's a perfect look at his face, too.
Cost him 15.
Yeah, he's just talking about a bull over there.
Ball is past midfield now. 5:42 to play, 21-point margin, and a first down for Northern Illinois. Lynch going to take a shot downfield for Moore, and just beyond him, and Moore had a few steps.
That's the second time tonight. In the first quarter, you remember, Martell Moore, he got clear down the right sideline and missed it. And this time you can see him here in the slot. He's going to get on top of this coverage. Oh, he's down the bottom. Sorry. Bottom guy, and ran right past the corner. Safety couldn't get there in time. Another opportunity test. Second one tonight.
Second and 10. And this time they went underneath looking for Tommy Lee Lewis, and it'll make for a third and 10.
I'm going to be anxious to watch this Florida State team next year. We've talked about the offensive line. There's a lot of good young defenders coming back. You talked about the good recruiting class that they had there. They have some good young guys in the secondary. They've got to have to replace the quarterback, but you talked to Jimbo Fisher about that. He really likes what he has behind E.J. Manuel.
Florida State's going to use a timeout. They have so much depth at quarterback.
It'll be a 30-second timeout.
Jameis Winston, Jacob Coker, big redshirt freshman, goes 6'6", 227. Clint Trickett, of course, will be back. That was a fun New Year's Day of college football throughout. Saw some fantastic finishes. Northwestern grabbing themselves a bowl win, Pat Fitzgerald, and now
Pat.
Here. Florida State getting something that they desperately wanted, winning a BCS bowl. And you know the talk always ramps up for Florida State, and you know it's going to happen again. You talk about the talent they have coming back.
I tell you, Tess, it's impressive the amount of recruits put together, first team guys, and guys you haven't even heard of yet who are going to be outstanding players. You could see his eyes light up when he started talking about the younger players that he has coming up. I think he's done a fantastic job down here at Florida State. He took over from Coach Bowden and pushed this thing forward in a big way.
Jordan Lynch just mauled again by Vince Williams.
He's
the fifth-year senior, the team captain. He has been all over Jordan Lynch.
Two seniors tonight who have played just outstanding football, and you can just watch. They look like that they were spying it, that he was, his sole responsibility was Jordan Lynch, and he took care of it in a big way. But two seniors who played extremely well, Vince Williams number one and Pryor number two, maybe not in that order.
Fourth and 13 in this fourth quarter, going south on Lynch, and he's taken down by Nick Moody. Taken down to his knees. Sound familiar? Remember the quote from Jordan Lynch that he said was taken out of context but made national headlines this week, when he said, yeah, they're fast, they're physical, but they haven't seen anything like our offense. They're just like us. They're human too. If you cut them, they bleed. We plan on wearing them down in the fourth quarter. We plan on having them on their knees and then just keep pounding away. But it's been the other way with Florida State, taking Lynch to his knees. Now, Coach Carey told us, listen, the reporter that he talked to took that thing out of context, and I'm never speaking to that guy again. But
Here's the bottom line. It was put out there, and the Florida State defense took it as a challenge that they were going to shut down Jordan Lynch, and they have. And they gnawed on it for a while, and they took it to heart, as well as this offensive line.
Nick Moody.
Right after Jordan Lynch. A day ago, they were table mates at the coach's luncheon. They were sitting next to each other over salad. Now they're out there with one chasing down the other in the Orange Bowl.
I know, but that dessert looked pretty good.
Little key lime pie. And it was good, by the way.
Old Jordan Lynch, he's going to look back in this one. He's going to be disappointed. He's a guy who's a perfectionist. He'll give you everything he's got. Got himself another year, though.
Got so much attention this year. A lot of folks saying, listen, this kid could be a safety in the NFL. He's that kind of athlete, that kind of strength. Obviously, you've seen the lack of refined passing skill tonight. You know he's a hard-nosed runner, gritty kid, but just a good, tough athlete from the south side of Chicago.
Now, he's also a guy who needs some help. He can't do it all by himself. And so, you know, he's going to need some help from that offensive line, and they have a young offensive line. They got some guys hurt and banged up. That offensive line will be back and seasoned. They'll be better a year from now, and he'll be better for it.
A couple redshirt freshmen in the middle. Sophomore and left tackle. Third and five, E.J. Manuel's running option, and then just throws it out to the side as he was able to find Devontae Freeman.
3 minutes left. I don't know why you'd even have E.J. Manuel in there. Just run the football, get him out of there, and thank him.
Thank him for 4 years of great service. E.J. Manuel, 2 minutes and 58 seconds away from becoming just the second quarterback to win four consecutive bowl games in college football history. Pat White at West Virginia did it. And here's E.J. Manuel wrapping up a fine career at Florida State.
And a great kid.
He sure is.
Great kid, Joe. Very respectful, the kind of guy you want to represent your program.
Fourth and a couple links. Gator Bowl MVP took the Chick-fil-A. Last quarterback to get a win against Notre Dame last year up in Orlando in the Champs Sports Bowl had that victory against the Irish, who will be playing on this same field next Monday. Number one against number two, Notre Dame and Alabama.
A couple kids on that Northern Illinois defense, though, that I thought played pretty good here tonight. I thought Allen Baxter played himself a pretty good game. And Progar played himself a pretty good game. And I thought Ken Bishop played pretty well also.
On both sides of the ball.
Yeah.
Lead
yeah.
blocker as a fullback and stout defensive tackle as well. By the way, E.J. Manuel, those four bowl games we showed you, we often talk about turnovers and the effect on games. No interceptions in those four bowl games throughout his career.
Good for him. Yeah, you'll see him playing on Sundays.
Fourth and inches as they look to salt this thing away. And a flag comes in as they have the necessary yardage and will check the flag as Freeman was able to dive ahead for 2 yards.
Looks like it's going to be on the defense, probably lined up offsides.
Reminder that Thursday night on ESPN, it's the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. Number four, Oregon. Number five, K-State. Boy, it seems like just yesterday this was going to be your BCS National Championship game right here in Sun Life Stadium. A heck of a matchup, but on that one magical night back in November when they were each upset, and now they face off against each other. Chip Kelly in that dynamic offense.
Bill Snyder and that gritty, tough team led by Klein.
And then you want to see how they're going to be able to handle tempo. Now, you talk about a team that loves to run tempo.
Oh.
Chip Kelly has redefined how to run tempo. People try to copy it, but they can't. So that becomes a big factor in the game. And then on the other side, I think the way Colin Klein runs that option, Nick Aliotti's defense is going to have to be at the top of their game. They've got some good defenders up there, but he'll make the numbers work. Will Bill Snyder for him? And so that'll be a nice matchup.
Remember Oregon, time to get healthy. Towards the end of the season, they were getting really thin on that defensive line. So the break has probably served them very, very well.
A couple of really good-looking players up there, boy. They're fun to watch.
Here's a guy that's been fun to watch all night long. Lonnie Pryor. Got a kick out of Lonnie Pryor the other day. We told you he jumped into Jimbo Fisher's final media session, as Fisher's going to get wet here in a second, and said, how can we get the fullback a little more involved?
That's one way to cool off the head coach.
Is that DJ Elliott? That's actually DJ Elliott.
Oh, yeah.
He's the defensive coordinator for tonight, soon to be defensive coordinator at Kentucky, and he gets a nice chilly exit. And Trickett comes in with E.J. Manuel calling it a night. Final 30 seconds here. What a career for E.J. Manuel. Remember his mother, Jackie, unable to be here with him tonight in Miami as she courageously battles breast cancer. And his thoughts undoubtedly with mom on a night where he caps his college career. Four consecutive bowl wins now for E.J. Manuel, and this the most special of all, the Discover Orange Bowl for Florida State. ...31-10 final. As Rod Carey and Jimbo Fisher meet up at midfield. Game number one for Rod Carey, and he runs into the Noles. To the field to Maria Taylor.
Coach, you said that this game was going to be a turning point for your entire program. Describe how it felt watching that clock wind down to double zeros.
It's the first BCS game we won in 12 years. We won 12 games, tied a school record. But just the momentum and where the direction our program is going, our kids learn to handle the big stage. We even overcome a lot of adversity tonight. We do in NIU in North Illinois. There was a great football team. It was very well coached, and we knew that they was going to play us tough with our kids. And it's another step in which we did handle the big platform, and I'm very proud of them. Happy for them.
And what about your seniors? You talk so much about their character, what they've done for this program, and them to be able to go out on a win like this in a BCS bowl game.
They win two out of three games their freshman year to get in the bowl game. They left us 12-2, tied school record, top 10 finish in a BCS game. How much character they have, and they've set the pace and the standard for the future.
And as you look into the future for Florida State football, who would you remember most and E.J. Manuel, the career that he's had here?
What the character and competitor he is, and he's the class, and he's a great face of our organization.
Thanks, Coach.
Hey, and good luck, and his mom, we all love you. Get well.
We're all thinking about you, Jackie. First BCS Bowl in 7 years for the Noles. When we come back, the Ford BCS postgame show, the trophy ceremony, and a wrap-up right after this. Jimbo Fisher has won himself a BCS Bowl, the Discover Orange Bowl.
Hey there, Steve Levy with Scott Van Pelt coming up on SportsCenter New Year's Day, owned by college football, Michigan and South Carolina, down to the wire.
Stanford makes a statement in the Rose Bowl, plus see the hit of the season. SportsCenter after the game, also on Twitter. Hey, Van Pelt, you're tall. Yeah, it's not new.
This postgame report is presented by the all-new Ford Fusion. Go further.
Joe Tessitore and Matt Millen as we welcome you to the Ford BCS post-game show here at Sun Life Stadium. The conclusion of the 79th Discover Orange Bowl as they are partying are the Noles, defeating Northern Illinois 31-10. But Matt, I'll tell you, this thing was a game late into the third quarter. It was 17-10. Northern Illinois had momentum. They had the onside kick. They were driving, and then Terrence Brooks comes up with a key interception, and then the Florida State attack that you thought you'd see all night started to roll.
Yeah, and that was the piece of the puzzle that I had been waiting for really all night. And what it came down to was just a power running game and allowing that offensive line to just do their job, and then Lonnie Pryor taking advantage of it. And, you know, in this game, when you're just off by a little bit, you saw the linebacker not making the right fit, and he was out the gate. Lonnie Pryor had himself a big night here tonight. Over 130 yards rushing tonight. He just played extremely well and took advantage of the athletic dominance of that offensive line.
And of course, his quarterback, E.J. Manuel, the composure, the leadership, four straight bowl wins now, just the second to ever do that. Let's go down to the field to Maria.
E.J., I just saw you embracing your coach, Jimbo Fisher. What did he whisper in your ear as he walked away?
He's proud of me. You know, a lot of the hard work, the hard loving, you know, the hard coaching, all that kind of stuff, it pays off. These are situations and these are opportunities that it really pays off.
And you went 25-6 as a starter at Florida State. What do you hope your legacy is right now for the Seminoles?
I would just say a winner. You know, a guy that came in, didn't complain, just continued to work hard and always stayed steadfast. And I felt like I was a great leader to my teammates, and I had great leadership around me and the coaching staff as well as my other teammates. But I'm just excited, and I'll always be a Seminole. I'll bleed, grind, and go for the rest of my life.
All right, thanks, E.J.
All right, thank you.
Big night for E.J. Manuel. Let's go down to the trophy presentation to Mark Jones. Mark, take it away.
All right, thanks a lot, Joe. Joined right now by a host of jubilant coaches and players, and right now I'd like to get to the Orange Bowl president and chairman, Ford Gibson, for the presentation of the championship trophy.
Great, thank you. I appreciate it. On behalf of the Orange Bowl committee, I want to take the opportunity to thank everybody who's here and to take this opportunity to thank, in my opinion, the greatest bowl sponsor in the business, Discover. Thank you, David.
Thank you.
Okay. It was a great game tonight. I appreciate the effort. Northern Illinois will go down as one of the greatest teams in MAC history, and you guys have represented the conference extremely well, and I congratulate those. Now, I want to take this opportunity to present the 2013 Orange Bowl trophy to the Orange Bowl champions and Jimbo Fisher, the Florida State Seminoles. Yeah, absolutely.
Coach, I had a chance to do your game earlier this season against North Carolina State. A very disheartening, disconcerting loss. How were you able to get your team back on track and to this point where you win a BCS game?
Well, we learned some lessons from the year before, losing games and not let one become two. But we have so much character on this team. We have so much leadership. We have so many just great individual players as far as how they respond and how they affect the other guys. And our seniors wouldn't allow it. They said, listen, that's one loss. We played a bad half of football. We're going to move on. We can still win a championship, and they did.
You talk about your seniors. You got one beside you right here, Lonnie Pryor, a big night. E.J. Manuel, another inspirational leader. How significant was their contribution to the win tonight?
Well, you got to remember, we had to win two out of three games their freshman year to get in a bowl game. And a matter of fact, he and E.J. were the two that did it in the Maryland game that put us in a bowl game to keep the streak alive and to be at 6-6. And then for them to go to here to 12-2, a top 10 finish, a BCS championship, the first one in 12 years, tied a school record for wins. What these seniors have meant to this program and the legacy they left is tremendous.
All right, the Seminole Nation happy about this, and coach, a lot of momentum going forward through next year. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Right now I want to introduce the president and CEO of Discover, Mr. David Nelms. David.
Thank you. On behalf of millions of Discover customers, I want to congratulate you on being the MVP of the Discover Orange Bowl. Congratulations.
Lonnie, an incredible night for you. Four rushes. You were very, very efficient, 130 yards, a couple of touchdowns. How would you characterize what this night has meant to you wrapping up your career?
just a blessing. I'm just proud of the team, just what we did, and just came out here and played, but I couldn't do it without the offensive line, the receivers, but just a great team, and it's just a blessing. I'm just proud of, just happy, you know, just shocked and happy, I guess.
This was a night where Northern Illinois was hanging tough, and you guys came out at the beginning of the third quarter and really kind of seized some of the momentum. How were you able to do that?
We were talking at halftime in the locker room and just, hey, guys, we need to stay focused, go out here and just put them to sleep in and just go out there and do what we have to do. And we came out and did what we had to do.
All right, great way to wrap up your career. Congratulations.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right, the jubilant Florida State Seminoles, Joe Tessitore, back to you.
Thank you, Mark. Florida State, just their second BCS bowl win. You got to go back to the 99 game. Last time they did this. You see what's coming up on SportsCenter. More post-game coverage. Congratulations to Florida State. We'll be back with more from the Orange Bowl. But for now, we're going to get you to SportsCenter on a very special night here in South Florida. The Noles take it over the MAC champs 31-10.
This is SportsCenter.
Stanford comes up roses. Can they be the Alabama of the West? Meanwhile, in the Orange Bowl, Northern Illinois, yeah, Florida State was on their knee, but it was a victory formation. The SEC reigns supreme. Aaron Murray, a record day and a comeback win. Jadeveon Clowney starts a Heisman campaign with a hit of the postseason. A day after being fired, how soon might Andy Reid find his way back on the sidelines? Plus, Aaron Rodgers felt the pressure Sunday. Why he's now telling the Vikings to bring it. SportsCenter, right now. Hope it's been a nice start to the new year. We welcome you to SportsCenter with Steve Levy. I'm Scott Van Pelt. We'll be heading down to Miami, at least some of us shortly, for the title game. Tonight, Steve, same stage, different BCS game.
When the matchups were first announced, you might recall that no bowl got more attention than the Orange. That was largely due to Northern Illinois' presence. Eighth time a school crashed the BCS party. First time that school didn't have a perfect record. Say hi to the Huskies of NIU taking on Florida State, the Discover Orange Bowl. No MAC team has ever won a BCS game. Here we go, and it didn't start great for him. E.J. Manuel hands it off to Lonnie Pryor. Pryor had a ridiculous game, ridiculous hole, ridiculous touchdown, 60 to the house. The much larger Florida State offensive line overpowering that NIU defensive line, 7-0 Seminoles. But keep in mind, we're approaching the half here. It's 7-3. I mean, the Huskies are very much in this game when Manuel scrambles, and it's Rashad Green. Great job to get his 1 foot down. So it's 14-3 Seminoles at halftime. 17-3 now in the third quarter. On third and 15, Jordan Lynch hits Akeem Daniels down the sideline. That's a 55-yard gain. They're in business. Later in the drive, it's Lynch to Martell Moore. Touchdown, and it's a touchdown game, 17-10. Ensuing kickoff, why not? Onside kick, Paris Logan recovers. Huge momentum swing after the onside kick on third and eight. Lynch, he's a triple threat. He can run, he can pass, he can also punt. Had a great punt in this game, but he can also do that. He is picked off, intercepted by Terrence Brooks. So NIU failing to capitalize after that great onside kick recovery. Fourth quarter, Florida State knocking on the door. Manuel calls his own number, touchdown, 24-10. And they're just gonna pile on here on the reverse fumble. Xavier Rhodes recovers for Florida State. Now the play would be reviewed. Take another look at it. Deron Brown appears to be in losing possession before his knee hits the ground. Ruling on the field was confirmed Florida State's ball, and then it's Pryor. What a game for Pryor. Had a career-high 134 yards and two touchdowns on five carries. How about that? We go back to Miami now. It's the Ford post-game report with Joe Tessitore.
Thank you very much, Steve. As Florida State is celebrating here, I think this is one of the things that people may have missed. There were some saying, how would Florida State approach this game, Matt? Do they want to be here? Would they be up for an opponent like Northern Illinois? A look at the scene you're seeing with the celebration here. This means the world to them to be called champions of the Orange Bowl. This is a team that had to grow into it. Remember, Florida State, I know the big brand name, but recent success hasn't been there at this level. Jordan Lynch, so much talk about him. They got after him tonight.
Yeah, they really did. They got after him in the pass game. They got after him in the run game. And he had about 40 yards rushing. And really, at the start of this game, we said it. He was their offense. And we said they had to punish him. And, Joe, they did. They punished him early. They punished him all night long. He's got good speed, but he doesn't have Florida State speed. And that showed up here tonight. He couldn't get to the edge, and they just pounded him.
He entered the game averaging 364 yards of total offense. Florida State held him to 220 tonight. 44 rushing yards for Lynch. Remember, he led the nation among quarterbacks in rushing yards. He was dynamic running the ball all year long. He could only get 44 tonight. Meanwhile, Matt, E.J. Manuel, solid, consistent, and playing with an emotional tie back home as his mom is battling breast cancer and couldn't be here tonight. Jackie's back home in Virginia Beach.
Well, first of all, Jackie, we want you to get better. I mean, keep up doing what you're doing. That's the main thing, number one. And number two, E.J. Manuel played phenomenally because the guys in front of him played even better. That offensive line was outstanding and allowed E.J. Manuel to throw the ball seamlessly. He was able to be accurate, and then he was able to hand the ball off. And again, the offensive line with Lonnie Pryor just allowed him to get his 134 yards on just five carries, Des. He had an outstanding game and a great way to finish his career.
I guess they figured out a way to get the fullback the ball. Pryor joked around with Jimbo Fisher this week, acting like a reporter. He said, Coach, how can we get the fullback the ball more? Well, you run like that, you get the ball more. By the way, just to wrap up, E.J. Manuel, four consecutive bowl wins, only the second man to ever do that, a quarterback in major college football. Never threw an interception over his college career in those four bowl wins. And tonight, he wasn't sacked.
Yeah, and he got by with a little help from his friends to borrow a Beatles line. And so that's where I'm at, stuck in the 70s or 60s. But that 60s or 70s, it's the same rules all the way through. You have a good offensive line, your quarterback can play any kind of football he wants. And he was flawless tonight because that offensive line was flawless as well.
Florida State, second BCS bowl win, 99 the last time. They will be celebrating here in South Florida deep into the night. 31-10 win in the Discover Orange Bowl. Let's get you back to Sports Center. Steve?
The Ford BCS report is brought to you by the all-new Ford C-Max Hybrid. Go further.
Landscape in college football has changed drastically in the last 5 years, but the Rose Bowl remains something of a constant, a North Star. Setting sun in Pasadena creates one of the most idyllic scenes in the sport, where today the subtle differences in Cardinal and Red speak to the similarities of the two programs. Neither Stanford nor Wisconsin is the most glamorous in its conference, but each stands on its own merit and its accomplishment, and both prefer a rugged brand of football, which was on display. There it is. What a beautiful scene it is. Barry Alvarez, the athletic director, coaching on an interim basis, won three Rose Bowls when he coached the Badgers back from 90 to 2005. Stanford, on the other hand, playing in this one for the first time since 2000. Trick play, Drew Terrell, Jamal Rashad Patterson, what a catch. 34-yard gain, top play nominee, spinning the wrong way, goes up and squeezes it. Stanford in business to do business. I talked about rugged brand of football, and they go and do that, and then let's do it the Stanford way. Line up, run the football. Stephon Taylor running right, gives it off to Kelsey Young, 16 yards. Key to the play, SportsCenter scope shows you what happened. Scotty linebackers all go the wrong way, and you understand why. Everybody's worried about Taylor. Off that fake, it's Young who's got a blocker out in front and all that beautiful emerald green grass to the end zone. Stanford leads quickly 7-0. Next Stanford drive, it's Taylor. 14-0, the Cardinal in the middle of the first out a couple of scores. Wisconsin trying to get themselves back in this game. Kurt Phillips, third different Badger quarterback of the year, and stoinks it there. Jared Abradaris grabs it. What happens? Goes right out the face mask of Henry Anderson. It's end over end, but Abradaris is able to squeeze that. Monte Ball, one of the most prolific players in the history of NCAA football, to the paint himself. It's 14-7. The Badgers cut the lead in half. Just over a minute to play in the first half. Scotty's down 10. Not anymore. Phillips, Sam Arneson. First down. And you see A.J. Tarpley. He's got his hands on it for a split second, but it's Arneson who grabs it. First and goal for the Badgers. Phillips, Jordan Frederick. Rolling left, fires right. 17-14. We got a ball game in Pasadena as the sun is setting, like I was talking about. Defense carried the day for both squads in the second half. Three-point game. Phillips looking for Chase Hammond. Looks like he's going to grab it. But Hammond gets blasted by Jordan Richards right there. Closed the gap quickly. Wisconsin was forced to punt. Fourth quarter, third and one. This is really the story of the day. Wisconsin in third and short, and that Stanford defense stood tall. Ball held to 87 in the first half, 13 in the second. Here, after a Stanford field goal made it a six-point game, Uswa Umanam with the pick. Stanford gets a first down. They clock it. David Shaw, rising star, his program wins the Rose Bowl.
Andrew Luck deserved and deserves a lot of credit and a lot of attention for what he has done with us and what he's doing now in the NFL. But the thing that we knew is that we had a good team. The thing that Andrew knew was he had a good team around him. People gave him so much credit, but nobody was talking about our running game. You know, nobody was talking about our offensive line. Nobody's talking about our front seven, how special those guys were last year and this year. And our guys knew if we played smart and played together and played hard, we're going to have ourselves a chance to be right here.
The only thing that's different than the teams, the other teams that I coach, were we found a way to win, and we weren't fortunate enough to get a win today.
It's heartbreaking. You'd like to send out guys like Monty the right way, and we couldn't get it done today. Like Coach said earlier, kind of been a microcosm of our whole season. Faced some adversity, fought back, and came up short. So just very disappointing.
Back to the Stanford side of the ledger. There's no question Jim Harbaugh revitalized the Stanford program during his time in Palo Alto. But for those who thought it was just a coach and a quarterback that moved on to the NFL, you sold David Shaw and his program short. He's 23-4, and that's the first Rose Bowl win since the Cardinal, who had a quarterback named Plunkett, kids Google it, back in 71.
Brings up a great question. What would an NFL team pay for David Shaw's services right about now? We won't know for a while. Those Stanford folks are pretty smart, and this past Wednesday, they quietly locked up Shaw with a contract extension 5 days before the NFL would have at least seven head coaching openings. From the Cardinal to the Cardinals, Arizona's search to replace Ken Whisenhunt is well underway. They formally interviewed their own defensive coordinator, Ray Horton, today. They'll meet with Broncos offensive coordinator Mike McCoy this weekend. And between now and then, the Cards will sit down with Andy Reid. They'll do so tomorrow. Here's John Clayton.
It shouldn't be surprised that Andy Reid is emerging as one of the leading candidates for the Arizona Cardinals. Andy Reid can fix an offense as he did in Philadelphia, and that's what's going to be needed in Arizona. Also, too, he can fix up Kevin Cobb, whom he drafted back when he was with the Philadelphia Eagles. Something could be wrapped up by the end of the week, but remember, for this to get done, Andy also has to understand where other teams are going to be involving him, whether it's going to be San Diego, Kansas City, or any other team that would be interested in Andy Reid. But Arizona could get this deal done by the end of the week. Clearly, he is one of their main candidates. As far as the next opening, you know, you'd have to think that maybe it would be the Chicago Bears, because they got a very long list and they're very aggressive. You know, they're going to lean toward the offensive side, and if that's going to be the case, we'll see if it's going to be an assistant or if they try to get Andy Reid.
All right, here's a look at the Cardinals' opponents for next season. You see the obvious, the standard home and home in the division, but take a look at the last team on the right. I mean, is that NFL luck or what? I mean, they just get every break.
Ended really bad. It was really bad at the end.
If, in fact, Andy Reid is the head coach of the Cardinals, of course, they play not against the Eagles. They play in Philadelphia next season. Come on.
Amari makes his debut. Melo returns and drops 45. Would it be enough as the Knicks were pushed? They were just hoping for overtime. Meanwhile, what a day it was on the comeback trail for Georgia, and the hit of the year.
The Discover BCS National Championship on ESPN. The BCS lives here.